Lies, lies, and more lies. Hillary stood poised with an air of smug arrogance. Donald stood by, reserved and battle-worn after enduring, along with the American people, a unification of fraud from the globalist bought and paid for mainstream media propaganda machine. The tremendous amount of scathing info from WikiLeaks. Another torpedo to the sinking battleship of the Democrats from James O'Keefe and the Veritas Project, and the FBI's announcement that a four-star general will face prison time for charges that are dwarfed by Hillary's email breach of our national security. The stench of BS hung heavy in the air.
In a speech you gave to a Brazilian bank for which you were paid $225,000, we've learned from the WikiLeaks that you said this, and I want to quote, "My dream is a hemispheric common market with open trade and open borders." So that's
Thank
the
you.
Question. That's the question. Please quiet everybody. Is that your dream, open borders?
Well, if you went on to read the rest of the sentence, I was talking about energy. You know, we trade more energy with our neighbors than we trade with the rest of the world combined. And I do want us to have an electric grid, an energy system that crosses borders. I think that will be a great benefit to us. But you are very clearly quoting from WikiLeaks. And what's really important about WikiLeaks is that the Russian government has engaged in espionage against Americans. They have hacked American websites, American accounts of private people, of institutions. Then they have given that information to WikiLeaks for the purpose of putting it on the internet. This has come from the highest levels of the Russian government, clearly from Putin himself, in an effort, as 17 of our intelligence agencies have confirmed, to influence our election. So I actually think the most important question of this evening, Chris, is finally, will Donald Trump admit and condemn that the Russians are doing this and make it clear that he will not have the help of Putin in this election, that he rejects Russian espionage against Americans, which he actually encouraged in the past? Those are the questions we need answered. We've never had anything like this happen in any of our elections before.
That was a great pivot off the fact that you want open borders, okay? How did we get off to Putin?
Do you condemn any interference by Russia in the American election?
By Russia or anybody else?
You condemn their interference?
Of course I condemn. Of course I can. I don't know Putin.
I have no idea. I never met Putin.
This is not my best friend. But if the United States got along with Russia, wouldn't be so bad. Look, she's been proven to be a liar on so many different ways. This is just another lie.
Well, I think when the middle class thrives, America thrives. And so I'm telling you right now, we're going to write fairer rules for the middle class, and we are going to raise taxes on the middle class.
Is your plan basically more, even more of the Obama stimulus?
Well, it's a combination, Chris. And let me say that when you inherit the level of economic catastrophe that President Obama inherited, I personally believe that the steps that President Obama took saved the economy. He doesn't get the credit he deserves for taking some very hard positions.
I was wondering what happened with my rally in Chicago and other rallies where we had such violence. She's the one in Obama that caused the violence. They hired people, they paid them $1,500, and they're on tape saying, be violent, cause fights, do bad things, which is a criminal act, by the way, where they're telling people to go out and start fistfights and start violence. And I'll tell you what, in particular in Chicago, people were hurt and people could have been killed in that riot. And that was now all on tape, started by her.
Well, I would like to say to everyone watching tonight that I'm reaching out to all Americans, Democrats, Republicans, and independents, because we need everybody to help make our country what it should be.
You can put half of Trump's supporters into what I call the basket of deplorables.
I don't know about you, America, but how can we believe a word Hillary says? And why should we? John Bound for InfoWars.com.
Start your engines. Main transmission begins now. 18 days. 18 days to the general election. I'm your host, Alex Jones. We're going to be here for the next 4 hours. We have a bunch of extremely informative guests joining us. But I'm going to focus as best I can, just making a public announcement. I'm going to try to not get too out of breath, not get too hysterical. But there's so many facets to this. We have Donna Brazile, one of the main henchmen of the Democratic Party crime machine, one of the top generals, on Fox News telling Megyn Kelly that she will not be persecuted and that she didn't get a question from a previous debate weeks before the debate took place, which CNN admits they did. And the WikiLeaks email is real. But she just lies to everyone and says that's not her reality. And this is all about these people controlling reality and literally trying to mind control us. That's a theme that came up today when I was going through hundreds of these stories where you've got EPA courts and federal government institutions and czars telling Congress and telling other people, I will not talk to a climate denier. Now, in and of that is multiple mind controls. First, it was global freezing in the 70s. Then it was global warming in the 80s and 90s and 2000s. Now the UN got caught hiding the decline, red-handed, fixing the temperature rates with thousands of universities. So then it just became climate change. Then it's climate. You are denying climate. No, I'm not denying climate. That's like denying that, again, there's air or there's water. It's craziness. EPA chief, I'm not talking to climate deniers. And I've got several other articles where other people in the federal government are saying the same thing. We're in charge. We say what reality is. Obamacare is free. You can keep your doctor. Thank God the public's so dumb. Ha, ha, ha. And it's the same thing over and over again. I was listening to local talk radio this morning, and I tuned into National Public Radio, and then I was obviously talking to folks here at the office and just canvassing the public. And I was looking at the headlines, the New York Times, you name it. It was this wall of disinformation that Trump is just so outrageous. He's done something that in our history's never been done. He's so un-American that he is saying he's planning to contest the election if he doesn't win. No, what he said is, I'm going to wait and see. We got 4 million people that are either dead or who aren't supposed to be on the rolls. We've got reports coming out all over the country of election fraud. There's a history of it. We've got Democratic Party officials caught on undercover videos admitting it. I mean, these are the head people in the country. People for the American way. I mean, that's the top of the food chain with these folks. And the entire media acts like he's completely insane and has 14 heads and is from Mars. When, as I keep hammering, and finally this is starting to come out, Al Gore contested the election. It went to the Supreme Court. Antonin Scalia was the deciding person. Notice he got taken care of. This is so obvious. Does anyone remember 15 years ago? 16 years ago? Does anyone remember the 1960 election, which they certified was fraud in Illinois and Texas? Does anyone remember the Diebold machines in Ohio and the state certifying that fraud happened just a few years ago? I mean, there are so many thousands of certified examples. I caught election fraud where Patrick J. Buchanan, is that his middle name? Won Travis County. I was there volunteering. They still made you take like $2 an hour for some reason, but I would go volunteer for the elections at the main center. It's where I wanted to be. And I was there helping stack all of it up and seeing him winning by a landslide. He got like 5-6% in Travis County at the end of the night. I went, started them to force a recount, and the state said, you know what? You're right. We're still certifying it. But yes, it was fraud. I have been at the Capitol and at the State House, and I have been at the County Commissioner's Court when the thing gets certified and they admit it's a fraud. Personally, look it up, microfiche and newspaper. Alex Jones contesting the election. Because I'm a kook, folks, because I care, because I'm involved, because I know history. And it's the same thing here. Trump knows in internal polls he's 5, 10, 15 points ahead, depending on the state. He's going to win by a landslide. Hillary can't even get a crowd of 200 people. He's got 30, 40, 50,000 everywhere he goes. Everyone knows this. The mainstream media knows this. CNN put out a new poll again last night, and guess what they did again? They oversampled Democrats, the Republicans, and put it in the methodology. Now, even in cooked polls, he's ahead right now. He destroyed her last night. He did miss some big opportunities when she was smirking about, you know, dead people in Syria when she's the author of it and, you know, so many other points. And he should have hit her during the debate, not just in a tweet, and said, "How you should give money back from Saudi Arabia and Qatar. They've given you over $100 million, and they cut women's genitals off. How dare you keep saying I'm abusing women with these cockamamie made-up stories that I patted somebody on their butt 15 years ago on a frickin' airplane, you witch." Excuse me. So I said, I'm going to settle down. But, man, there's only so much of the lying and twisting and disinfo I can take, okay? But we're putting together a video, a short one, but it's highly produced, that shows the history, the clips, all of it. But luckily, this, you know, it's not done yet, but I kind of saw it organically already on the Daily Caller and Breitbart and Drudge, where everybody's kind of going, hey, here's a clip of Al Gore contesting. Hey, here's a clip of where they just contested here. Here's a clip of Democrats, you know, 15 times saying Trump's going to rig the election. And that's what's crazy. Hillary on her plane last night, this is what makes smoke come out of my ears. In her little stage press conferences, you know, she won't do a real one, but she has her little lap dogs and, you know, they roll oranges at her. I'm not kidding. If you're a new listener, folks, they actually roll oranges at her to ask her questions. But sometimes she pops up and hangs in the doorway like a vampire bat, and then they ask her questions. And she's sitting there perched, and she goes into how ridiculous it is that he says he won't accept the election. No, he said he's going to wait and see if there's full theft going on. There's already evidence of it. As he said last night, 4 million people on the rolls shouldn't be there. Democrat chicanery. And then, I've got the time code here. 2.5 minutes later, she goes into the Russians are trying to overthrow the election. I mean, where is the... Reporters are sitting there going, oh, that he says the election might be stolen, the super key election. Oh, no, that's totally insane to say there might be some type of hanky-panky. Oh, my God, this is so bizarre. You know, it's like saying if you throw your baby in with starving hyenas, they might eat the baby. Oh, that's ridiculous. Oh, my gosh, if you slit your wrist and jump into a pool of piranhas, they might bite you. I mean, he is such a kook. I mean, if you pour gasoline all over yourself and light it, you might get third-degree burns. I mean, what a kook. I mean, if you take a shotgun and shove it in your mouth with 12-gauge and pull the trigger, it might blow your head off. That's crazy. If you take a meat cleaver to your fingers, it'll cut them off. That's the kind of crazy crap he's saying. He says if you take a slice of butter and put it on bread and it's hot toast, it'll melt. He said, if you don't breathe air, you'll suffocate. Oh, yeah. This guy's a freaking demon, okay? You know why? Because he said 2 + 2 = 4, and that's a crime with these people because these people are a cult. And I already knew this, but watching them, they really think they're controlling reality as con artists, and they look at you with this dead stare. Like Donna Brazile looks like a dead person. She looks like a dead person rotting in the sun that they've somehow reanimated. I'm sorry, she does. And then she just sits there and lies about WikiLeaks. It's all a con game with these people. I mean, it's just crazy. So we're sitting here dealing with all of this. And what do you do when they're constantly saying elections are fraudulent? Both sides have always been caught cheating. It's constantly going on. We have all the Democratic officials saying they're already cheating as we speak. Hillary says it's completely kooky. There's no such thing as election fraud. So does the president. But then meanwhile, out of the next statement out of their mouth, they talk about the Russians, we've got to guard the election. They are at war with reality. So when we come back from break, we've got a whole bunch of these clips, and I'm going to just play them here, and then hopefully you can take this video and send this on to your Democratic friends and just say to them, listen, I don't care if you don't want to vote for Trump. That's fine. But at least admit this is an attempt to overthrow reality. Because to say that Trump is evil and Trump is bad and Trump is upsetting our republic and our democracy and all this, when he's saying, I'm going to wait and see what happens with this election, this is highly contested, We got 4 million people in there that shouldn't be voting. The Democrats say they're going to be cheating. And guess what? We've got new WikiLeaks with Podesta. And he's in there saying we've got to get driver's licenses to the illegal so they can vote. But that's no secret. Seven or eight states tried to pass laws last year. And again, they passed the houses in several states. Going to governor's desk, what was it, in Illinois, California, and one other, went to the desk. But the governors didn't sign them because it would be too obvious. There it is. Podesta, it's okay for illegals to vote with driver's license. WikiLeaks. I mean, that's the whole point. Is you're here, they give you a driver's license, which all these states are doing, and then you can go vote. But they don't even want that. They're saying, don't even have that. Just don't even just show up and just whoever you are, you can vote. I mean, this is beyond insane. And they sit there with a deadpan straight stare and say, Donald Trump has just sunk to a new low when he said he was going to wait and see what happens. He's already stole the nomination. I'd say he's already illegitimate, which he said last night. All right, this is a short segment. I want to get more into the election fraud, and then I want to go through the next segment, some of the history of the Democrats claiming, alleging, and also proving election fraud, because both sides do it. It's well known. Democrats are more famous for it overall. That's just a fact. Everybody knows about JFK stealing it from Nixon and the rest of it. But it happens. And so for Obama a few months ago to say, what is election fraud? It doesn't exist. Don't listen to that guy from Texas. And then to go on and have his surrogates come out and say, oh, my God, the Russians are hacking our election. We've got to, you know, basically federalize it. Really shows you how stupid they think you are. Where they want you to hold two conflicting ideas in your head at the same time that they are telling you are both true. So first, here's Obama, obviously, a few days ago, saying to Trump that he needs to, quote, stop whining.
I have never seen in my lifetime or in modern political history any presidential candidate trying to discredit the elections and the election process before votes have even taken place. It's unprecedented. It happens to be based on no facts. Every expert, regardless of political party, regardless of ideology, conservative or liberal, who has ever examined these issues in a serious way will tell you that instances of significant voter fraud are not to be found, that, keep in mind, elections are run by state and local officials, which means that there are places like Florida, for example, where you've got a Republican governor.
Okay, let's stop right here. So he's saying basically Trump's a liar. He goes on to say, stop whining. We'll play that clip when we come back from break, that part of it. But this is crazy. He's restating the lie that, A, there's no such thing as election fraud. No serious expert says there is. We have a whole bunch of clips of Democrats in 2008, 2004 saying there's election fraud, quote, quote, we got to stop it, Al Gore, the rest of it. So he's lying to you there. But then he knows full well what Pew Research and others show. Between 4, maybe 6 million, but 4 is the low number, people that shouldn't be on the voting rolls are dead people that are voting. And we have Democrats all over the country. That's their specialty, is election fraud, organizing individual voter fraud. And they always try to confuse the public and the media about that, too. Like, this individual fraud's very, very rare, and it's only a few people doing it. Well, yes, it's rare for someone individually to go out and try to vote in somebody else's name. Because it's organized, because they have the voter list. They have the computer list of people that don't vote, but who they've kept on the list, or dead people. I mean, CNET News, all of them know this is true. It's indisputable. But here's a clip on Pew Research, one of the top research groups out there that Trump was quoting last night.
Well, listen, if you think that the election system in this country is outdated, old, you're absolutely right. Pew Study did a research into this, says that it's a system plagued with errors and inefficiencies. But let me give you some numbers to really bring that home. According to Pew, 24 million people, one of every eight, voter registrations in the U.S. are no longer valid or significantly inaccurate. More than 1.8 million dead people are listed as voters. So you could use that name to go ahead and vote. Approximately 2.75 million people, 2.75 million people are registered in more than one state. So that is outlines, I think, the possibility of voter fraud.
Yeah, so you add that up, it's over 4 million, but 20 plus million total. So you could sit there and look at the obituaries a month before and pick two or three people's names that you want. And then you could go in and try to vote, because most states don't make you have an ID. And if they say that's not on the roll, you say, well, I should be. You just go walk in another precinct and try another name. And you try a couple, you're going to hit a voter. Now, that's how an individual could do it. It's very rare, but that's how an individual could do it. But if you're the Democratic Party, they have the computer databases. They have the voter rolls. Many times the Democratic Party has the county clerk who's over all that, working with them to carry out the fraud. In fact, that's generally who quarterbacks it, in my experience in Texas, is the county clerks. And it is a very dirty business indeed. Texas is famous for fraud. I'm proud of my state, but Texas probably has as much election fraud as even New York or Illinois. And they're the other king daddies of it. But these are key battleground states, always are big states, because there's a large turnout and a large number of people, so they're big prizes too. Now, when we come back, I'm going to get into more facts for the president, who's never heard of election fraud and just has never heard of anyone saying we should, you know, check the integrity of our system. But that's all Trump's doing, is putting light on this so they don't get away with it. He's letting them know he's going to contest. All right, get ready, because I'm going to lay out the total proof of the conscious lying of the unified media. That no one's ever heard of election fraud, that it's unprecedented what Donald Trump is doing, and that it's just crazy to allege it even exists. I even forgot, I got another clip I didn't give you guys of Carville. James Carville going, well, of course there's fraud. Raging Cajuns, of course there's fraud. I mean, what do you think's going on here? It's just over the top that they're telling you. It'd be like if Donald Trump said, I'm worried about bank robberies. We need more police outside banks, because there have been a slew of bank robberies if he was a mayor. And they go, well, that's just ridiculous. No one's ever heard of a bank robbery. Why, well, I see. Again, it's the way they talk to us like we're 2 years old. And not a very bright toddler either. Now new news of Bill Clinton mistresses and women he reportedly raped and abused is coming out. I mean, it is just getting crazy. But before we go there, I want to thank the listeners for their support, for spreading the word, for your prayers. Last night, I got a little bit mad a few times at Hillary, and I'm very honest about it. And I don't claim to be a very Christ-like person in many ways. But I will say this. Christ went and made a scourge, basically a cat or nine tails, and went in and beat the money changers because they were so corrupt, and overturned the tables and basically kicked their butts. And I'm not calling for violence. I'm saying at a certain point, we have to overturn the tables. We have to stop being calm and putting up with all this. And so sometimes I get a little bit ashamed of how I act on air. Everybody seemed to love it, actually, when I started calling Hillary, you know, a lying whore. And it's not nice to ladies of the night that, you know, compared to a lot of professions, it's pretty honorable. Honorable when compared to, say, a, you know, globalist or one of these New World Order banker types or people that, you know, sell cluster bombs and drop on kids. But when I say a whore, I mean a whore of Babylon. And they make jokes and go, oh, look, he's crazy. He's not an atheist like us pinheads. He's making, you know, literary connections to archetypal evil. That's exactly what I mean. I could sit her all day and list her crimes, the horrible things she's done, smirking like a big plastic jack-o'-lantern demon. I mean, her face is a horror movie cover. Every time I talk about dead kids or radical Islam and her supporting it, or depression and war, that big demon face would come on that gives me the willies. I'll be honest, Hillary Clinton scares me. And by scares me, I'm not physically scared of her. Knowing that type of evil exists gives me the willies, is what I'm saying. I am repulsed by her, like when you open a drawer up at a Black Widow comes out and almost bites you. You're like, ugh! I mean, I guess I am scared of her. But it's like a repulsion. She's a revolting person, and her minions are revolting, stunted, demonic idiots. And I could sit her all day and list her crimes, and we do it. But at the end of the day, I've just got to be honest and get the poison out and just say how I feel about her. People could call me mean all day. I'm not carpet bombing countries. I'm not selling out missile secrets to China. I'm not funding radical Wahhabis to enslave millions of women and put little 8-year-old girls and 6-year-old girls by the thousands into sex slavery. I mean, these radical Muslims she's funding and supporting are the nastiest, craziest, evilest people I've ever heard of. I mean, they're worse than stuff out of, you know, nightmare novels. They're horrible. And they're oppressive, and they just are everything that the West and the Renaissance stands against. And that's why the West and the Renaissance has to be pissed on by the mainstream media all day and told how we're the guilty ones and we're the bad ones, because they know we are altruistic on average and care and want to build and want to have freedom, and the globalists don't want that. That's why they're allied with the most twisted, dirty, backward, fetid, scrofulous-filled, flaky Islam. Now, before I go any further and get into the big news here and these clips and all this big presentation we've got ready, as I said, I want to thank the listeners of the broadcast. I want to thank you for your support. We're only able to do all this because of your support. It's a win-win. We've really developed top-of-the-line nutraceuticals. We've really developed a lot of great T-shirts to spread the word, Molon Labe, anti-New World Order shirts, Hillary for Prison shirts, you name it. We're selling those right now at cost. Those shirts will be gone. This is the last run of those. We have the new Trump is my president shirt, an all-red shirt, to wear on election day, and then afterwards to point out that we are the majority, that we understand what's happening. Totally freaked them out in Cleveland and other areas when a third of the folks were wearing Hillary for Prison shirts. It really got to them big time. It was in thousands of newspapers. It was all over the news. Those are all available at InfoWarsStore.com. That's the big umbrella site. The subsection is InfoWarsLife.com. We have the big mega special that is going to end tomorrow. In fact, I will end it tonight. It's going to be over today. That's 25% off on our great nootropic Brain Force. Go read all the amazing ingredients. It would be a good deal at $50. It's normally, what, 30-something bucks? It is $22 right now, a great way to get introduced to Brain Force, and that supports the broadcast. This is a clean, healthy, good way to boost your mental capacity and to get those neurons firing. Sign up for AutoShip and get an additional 10% off, InfoWarsLife.com. But store-wide at InfoWarsStore.com and InfoWarsLife.com, store-wide free shipping right now on top of all of that, and we have several other specials on the site. Living Defense would be one of our very best sellers. The problem is it's got a whole bunch of ingredients. Each one has to be tested by the big laboratory to pass California standards, and then a lot of times nobody can hardly do that with one ingredient, much less 20-something. So then we have to keep sending stuff back until we get it at those standards. And so I'm talking about changing the formula so it doesn't have so many things in it, but that's what makes it good, is it has so many things in it. But it's hard to make something like this. It's like if you don't get the right grapes, you don't get the right wine. I mean, we will sell no wine before it's time. Well, something like Living Defense, a complex formulation, that's what it is. Parasite Cleanse, check that out. InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. Living Defense is back in. You can go read the rave reviews there at InfoWarsLife.com from third-party sites that we are linked to. And, of course, there's the great Sleep Aid Knockout. And if you've had too much Brain Force. And then there's so many other great products like DNA Force, Survival Shield, X2, Secret 12. Oh, and don't forget, because I'm going to take some right now. Selenium, the neuron fire. You die without it, and the deficiencies are in most people. The government keeps lowering the level they say you need. Let me tell you something. Selenium is the bomb, and we have the bio-true selenium from the mighty mustard seed. Take a moment right now. Talk about energy. Now, it's different for different people, but I personally get more energy from selenium than I do from even Brain Force. But it varies for everybody. You know what I mean? That's just how the metabolic systems work. So check out all the products, but bottom line, you're funding our operation, and you know that that's having a huge effect out there. So it's a total win, 360 win. But thank you for your prayers. Thank you for your support and more. InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. And in closing, I want to encourage everybody to become sponsors of our local affiliates. Support local sponsors. Let them know why. Spread the word about that station. And quite frankly, volunteer for the station if you can. Give them a donation, because there's a war to shut down talk radio, a war to get True Patriots off radio right now. And we're growing on the number of stations because our listeners are supporting them and the ratings are very, very good. Even on smaller stations, within a year or so, we defeat the bigger stations in the area. Then a phenomenon happens once the ratings go up. They come in and buy out the airtime and put on ESPN or other things. But that is a phenomenon. In fact, we're well known for that now. That's the formula. That's exactly what people have done all over the country. So I don't care. A lot of times we get on a station about a year, the ratings go from nowhere to number one or number two, and then they sell the timeout. But that's whatever it takes for folks to survive. But we're changing the world together right now, and it's a very, very special time to be alive. So I want to thank everybody out there for supporting our local affiliates. Thank you. Now, it frustrates me at a very deep level that mainstream media is organized against the American people. But the good news is they've been so brazen, so naked, so open about it that their ratings have gone from horrible to almost non-existent. I mean, they are facades now, and the establishment combines, like Carlos Slim, you know, the global kingpin of Mexico, just props up the New York Times. It admittedly loses tons of money every year. I mean, the thing is a joke. But it has all this so-called fake prestige, but only with the most uneducated and wannabe trendies. Not with the educated anymore. They know it's a joke. But with wannabe intellectuals and liberals, it still is the gold standard. And it's a bellwether of everything else, but it is sinking fast. And that's their own doing. So are they backing off on the deception? No. The New York Times even writes articles we've read on air where they say, we're no longer even going to act like we're not biased. And then I see them on CNN, MSNBC, they'll announce, well, you know, this is the year that we showed our bias, and we're right to show our bias because Donald Trump's an evil racist, blah, 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 as if we needed you to tell us that you were biased all these years. Again, that's how delusional you are. You were hired because you were followers. You were hired because you'd read off a teleprompter. You were hired because you were narcissists that wanted to look at yourself in the mirror. You are nothing but repeaters. You're nothing but meat puppets, okay? You're a joke, but you're the perfect delusionites to go then try to push your delusion on the rest of us. It's not working. So here's Obama saying there's no such thing as election fraud and that Trump should stop whining while all of his surrogates and Hillary Clinton are running around saying the Russians are trying to hack the election, so we've got to federalize it. And in the same speech, he said there's nobody involved in local elections. The feds aren't involved when they've announced they're federalizing them. Again, they really think you're stupid. And I guess this election is a referendum on, is the public really this gullible and this dumb, or really just wants to get on a moron bandwagon? Here's the president.
But the larger point that I want to emphasize here is that there is no serious person out there who would suggest somehow that you could even rig America's elections, in part because they're so decentralized and the numbers of votes involved. There's no evidence that that has happened in the past or that there are instances in which that will happen this time. And so I'd advise Mr. Trump to stop whining and go try to make his case to get votes.
We have the leader of People for the American Way. You know, we're battling Joe McCarthy back in the day, same old suspects, and his national coordinator on video saying, we're going to effing do what we always do and have people vote 10 times apiece, bussing them around. And the police aren't going to stop us, and the courts aren't going to stop us. We got the Justice Department. Should I play those clips again? No, I already played them yesterday. Everybody knows about it on this show, nowhere on mainstream media, though. By the way, James O'Keefe's joining us today of Project Veritas. See, I don't get excited around Hollywood stars, folks, but I get excited with someone like James O'Keefe or Drudge. Or these are heroes, man. These are the real deal. Now, he's coming up. I'm getting excited here. Schoolgirl. Now, Here's just a short compilation. We're putting together bigger ones right now of the Democrats freaking out about election fraud that, remember, doesn't exist like in 2000.
The thing that has most animated this election on the Democratic side has been the sense of a rigged system.
The game is rigged against them.
So there's a sense the game is rigged.
Yes, this is what a rigged economy is about.
A rigged system.
They'll do anything to rig the system for those at the top.
The game is rigged against a lot of people who have done their dead level best.
That the system is rigged.
People say the game is rigged.
Keeps the system rigged for those at the top.
The system is rigged.
Their obstruction is keeping a system that is rigged.
The game is rigged.
We must fix an economy in America that is rigged.
The game is rigged, and it's not right.
A rigged economy.
The game is rigged.
And the economy is rigged.
The American people know that the system is rigged against them.
The system rigged against the middle class.
All I know, it is rigged. And it's still rigged.
Too many people feel like the system is rigged.
People say the game is rigged.
How the game is rigged.
Our economy is rigged.
People feel like the system is rigged against them. And here's the painful part. They're right.
You know, the system, folks, is
rigged. And he goes on to say the system's rigged. Now, that's them saying the system's rigged. But we have all the clips of them talking about election fraud. And the problem of that, and again, we're getting a bunch of clips together of them talking about the Russians trying to rig the election, specifically the election, and Jay Johnson saying he's federalizing the election. But everybody knows who's informed. They've done that. They've announced it. We played those clips. Now, next, some people are starting to argue that there wasn't an election fought over in 2000. There was. Al Gore contested it. It went to the Supreme Court. Remember the hanging chads, all that stuff? They'd like you to think that never happened. So here, we already played you Pew Research earlier, admitting 20-something million people that shouldn't be on the voting rolls, 4 million that we know the Democrats are manipulating. So flashback, Gore refuses to concede election, demands recount to ensure all the votes are counted. That happened. So Obama says he's never heard of a candidate saying anything like this in U.S. history. What about 16 years ago, my friend? Again, he thinks you're a moron. Here's Al Gore.
If you lose at the Supreme Court of Florida, what do you concede?
Well, the effort I have underway is simply to make sure that all the votes are counted, and when the issues that are now being considered in the Florida Supreme Court are decided, that'll be an important point. But I don't want to speculate on what the Florida Supreme Court will do.
So that happened. Now, Joe Scarborough, why do I not like Joe Scarborough? Because I know, like Newt Gingrich, he's very smart. He knows exactly what's going on. He's not stupid. He's on a show with the daughter of Zbigniew Brzezinski, one of the most evil men alive in the world, according to himself. He writes books bragging about it, about how, you know, all the horrible things he's done, and world government, and how we're stupid, and how the government brings in the drugs and controls the organized crime, and how that's a good thing. I mean, go read his books. I'm digressing. The reason I get mad at Scarborough is he'll say something totally true one day and then reverse it a week later. But what he's saying in this next clip is pure veritas. It's true that the Democrats are running around acting like they've never heard somebody say, I'm concerned about an election, when they are the ones that always scream the loudest. Which, again, goes to their arrogance.
Respect what Kellyanne Conway said. I don't quite understand what Mayor Giuliani is referring to, but this all happened after the race.
Right.
And in addition, Al Gore accepted the outcome of the Supreme Court decision. And my understanding is that from what Mr. Trump is saying, he may not be willing to accept the outcome.
No, what was the exact quote?
He said, leave you in suspense.
He said, I'll look at it at the time.
I'll look at it at the time.
Keep you in suspense. Right.
So that means he's not willing to say, I will accept the outcome. If you are
means is he'll look at it at the time. I love everybody saying, you know, I woke up to these screaming headlines saying Donald Trump will not respect election results. He actually said, I'll look at it at the time. I'll see.
Has there ever been a presidential candidate to say that?
If they're voting irregularities, then any presidential candidate, anybody, sure.
What would you have said? But we would all stand here and say that.
What would your response be to that question?
I said, yeah, certainly. I'll certainly respect the outcome of the election. I, of course, will want to make sure that
it's fair. Well, he didn't say that.
I will want to make sure that it's fair. It's on the up and up.
But he didn't say that.
Yeah, but you know what? This is an example. The media got something. They
they can absolutely freak out about and claim that he's an agent of Vladimir Putin and destroying democracy in America. And it's just another example of the media having to find a little phrase and freak out.
But Joe, he's
when, as a Republican, I have listened to Democrats talk about the only two times we won the White House in like 800 years that we stole both elections. I had to sit through Fahrenheit 9-1-1, and a lady was sobbing violently behind me on the Upper West Side about the election being stolen from George Bush, and I patted her halfway through and go, it's all right. It's all right, ma'am.
But Al Gore,
hold on. It's all right. It's all a lie anyway. Democrats have been whining for 16 years. They're still writing articles about how Bush stole the elections in 2000 and 2004. So this holier-than-thou attitude about this is the first time anyone has suggested that the election is not a sacrosanct process, it's a joke. So you guys bathe in that hypocrisy if you want to. I'd just like to hear how the debate went. Go ahead, Joe.
You can't. The difference is what Michael just said. It's the candidate himself. You will have spectators, voters, political officials, elected officials, all contemplating, writers saying that this didn't happen this way. They stole it. Bush did this. But you never had a presidential candidate do what he did last night.
My target this morning for my mockery are the very people that are writing articles today on their blogs that are saying this is a threat to democracy. The electoral process in America is sacrosanct. And if we ever doubt this, are we no better than Putin? I mean, those are the people I'm mocking. I'm not comparing him to Aaron.
All right, now, let's get to the meat and potatoes here. This is unprecedented to have him 20-something days out, now 18 days out, but he was doing this months ago, because he's not stupid. It's unprecedented to have them trigger regulations that the RNC and DNC created corporately in 1972 and 1976, respectively, to say, if we ever don't like a candidate, we'll ignore the popular will of the voters and the delegates in the primary, and we will appoint that person. And George Will coming out and saying, a mere plurality of voters doesn't matter. It is the sovereign party. I mean, I thought they were about to start playing God Save the Queen. He actually said, it is the will and the sovereignty of the party, not a mere plurality of voters. He wrote that for the Washington Post. They were all over TV saying, your vote doesn't count. And so the commentator would say, so you're saying the vote doesn't count and don't vote in the primary. Yes, we shouldn't even have primaries. The party decides. Everybody went, excuse me? There are election laws. You are just guardians of this. You're not allowed to do that. Let's go ahead and challenge that. And because he is a leader, because he should be president, he came out, Donald Trump, and said, I'm going to contest you trying to steal the nomination from me, when they would celebrate voterless victories in Colorado and other states. And the media was like, how dare Drudge get involved in the election again? We need to have the Federal Election Commission shut Drudge down, and InfoWars too. Remember that? Because they're putting up headlines that say another voterless victory for Ted Cruz. Well, there weren't votes. They were just announcing, oh, we're canceling the election now. We're canceling the primary. The party says it's Ted Cruz. Or he wins Louisiana, or he wins all these other states, and then they give the delegates to Ted Cruz. The same thing they did to Bernie Sanders for Hillary. But Bernie didn't do it. He rolled over like a good little socialist, didn't he? And got given a big lake house and a book deal and more goodies for his wife, who helped bankrupt and suck the university dry she ran. These people are locusts. Just look at them. They just fop around all day conning good people. They just scam artists around all day long. And so you've got him rolling over on all his constituents, laughing at him. And guess what? Donald J. Trump didn't do that, did he? That's what's unprecedented. And so he knows that they already tried to steal it. He fought for it, so he got it. And so now he's going to fight for it again, and so are we. And listen, you little con artists, you can't stand the fact your con games don't work on us. You can't stand the fact that we know your healthcare law was a scam meant to bankrupt things. It's now on the WikiLeaks. You can't stand straight shooters. But guess what? We're coming. And people like myself and Donald Trump, we're just the front line of this. There's so much more coming behind us. We're never going to stop. You just woke up the sleeping giant. You're going to get your ass kicked forever now. You understand that? Nothing's going to stop us. We're going to fight you. We're going to expose you. We got your number. Let's play the leader, Donald Trump.
Tell you one other thing. She shouldn't be allowed to run. She's guilty of a very, very serious crime. She should not be allowed to run. And just in that respect, I say it's rigged. Because she should never have been allowed to run for the presidency based on what she did with emails and so many other things.
But, sir, there is a tradition in this country. In fact, one of the prides of this country is the peaceful transition of power, and that no matter how hard fought a campaign is, that at the end of the campaign, that the loser concedes to the winner. Not saying that you're necessarily going to be the loser or the winner, but that the loser concedes to the winner, and that the country comes together in part for the good of the country. Are you saying you're not prepared now to commit to that principle?
What I'm saying is that I will tell you at the time. I'll keep you in suspense.
And, of course, before that, he went into the 4 million people on the voter rolls. It's actually 21 million. And he went into the folks that shouldn't be able to vote, and he went into all the stuff going on. But I would have just said, lady, you shouldn't even be here. You stole the nomination from Sanders. He would have destroyed them. And the Republicans were going to take it away from me, even though I had the delegates. Of course I'm saying it. We need to watch out for being rigged. If you got a neighbor next to you, you caught breaking into your house 3 times, could you start watching that neighbor and saying, you know, he got out of jail again. Keep the garage door locked. We need to move out of this neighborhood. We had to move out of a neighborhood once because it was one family down the street. And their kid was always going to jail and stuff. He was robbing everybody's houses, TVs, jewelry, you name it. My dad one time came home from work and saw him with one of our bicycles down the street, came and said, give the bicycle back. His dad, I guess, came out and threatened and stuff, and some things happened. But the point is that this is the type of stuff that goes on in this country. And we see Hillary with the bicycle in our garage, putting her fat ass on it, riding, and we're like, listen, that's our bicycle, lady. She's like, you never had a bicycle. This isn't a bicycle. This isn't the bicycle you're looking for. Racist, racist, racist. It doesn't work anymore. You stole it from Bernie Sanders in front of God in the world. You tried to steal it from Trump. We don't have memories of goldfish. I mean, the general public does, but what are you going to do about the rest of us? I mean, we know you're a pack of degenerate scumbag criminals, okay? That isn't rhetoric. You are an organized racketeering operation. The mainstream media, the big banks, the Democrats, the Republican leaders, you're all going to prison. That's the truth, so get ready to get your asses locked up. Okay. We've got Russia taunts U.S. with biggest military offensive since the Cold War. I love how our media spins that. I mean, I don't want a war with Russia, okay? And the fact is the West is trying to overthrow their country. Soros has tried to overthrow it internally with the same culture warfare garbage and anti-police riots. And you're like, what are you sticking up for the police for? It's their country. You can't have foreigners try to overthrow your government starting riots. I mean, that's espionage, people, and that's what's going on by these globalists. And they've got this giant fleet going now through the English Channel, and it's just the whole thing is deteriorating quickly. Now, we've got huge Project Veritas news breaking coming up with James O'Keefe at the start of the next segment. But first, just getting into mind control, getting into how they talk to us like we're idiots and say there's no such thing as election fraud, even though they're the biggest people bitching about it, like Al Gore. Donna Brazile freaks out after Megyn Kelly asked how she got debate question in advance. And I like the fact Megyn Kelly's trying to rehabilitate herself now and actually being a journalist. But CNN admits that the question was sent. They won't say exactly who. They've been caught. The email's real. And this woman sits there and tries to play dumb. And if you're a radio listener, you can't see Donna Brazile. But, I mean, she just is unbelievably arrogant. And has the deadest eyes I think I've ever seen. So let's go ahead and play that clip.
Say that, Donna. Kelly? You say that you play straight up. But I have to ask you because you were accused of receiving a debate question before a CNN town hall where they partnered with TV One, and that you had this question on March 12th. That verbatim was provided by Roland Martin to CNN the next day. How did you get that question, Donna?
Well, Kelly, since I play straight up, and I'll play straight up with you, I did not receive any questions from CNN. Let's just be
very
clear.
Where did you get it?
First of all, what information are you providing to me that will allow me to see what you're talking about? Everybody,
you got the WikiLeaks released a March 12th Podesta email showing you messaging the Clinton campaign with the exact wording of a question asked at the March 13th CNN TV1 town hall debate.
Kelly,
where did you get it?
I, as a Christian woman, I understand persecution, but I will not sit here and be persecuted because your information is totally false. Podesta's emails were stolen. You're so interested in talking about stolen
material. So you deny it.
You're like a thief that want to bring into the night the things that you found that was in the gutter.
You're a thief. Notice, she triggered liberation theology taught by the Ford Foundation all over the world to create race war based on the Christian religion. But the general public would know that she was activating folks saying, I'm a Christian, I know about being persecuted, and then was bringing up the entire slave experience, which they then want to reproject as a new trauma every time there's a problem. So what she did was brought race in there. The fact is, she's getting the questions beforehand. It's all rigged. It's all coming out. CNN admits it. And she's sitting there playing dumb about getting the questions to Hillary back during the Democrat debates. It's amazing. Well, there are few people that I can actually tell the audience that we would be in a situation five times worse if it wasn't for them. There are only a few of those people. And one of them is James O'Keefe. And he is an example, even though he doesn't like me saying this, to everybody else on how you can go out and take on these criminals. And the stalwart, dogged determination is the stuff of Americana and the stuff of legend. And I'm only saying that because he gets demonized, he gets dogged, he gets attacked, he gets lied about, he gets arrested, fighting true organized crime, real organized crime. And he deserves our prayers, and Project Veritas deserves your financial support. You should get his book that chronicles all this. I know he didn't want to come on and talk about himself, but there's three big things to cover today. A, the mainstream corporate media is totally blacking out the reports he's putting out that are the biggest in their storied history. Bringing down Acorn, you name it, on and on and on. This is the biggest stuff in my view. I mean, he has top Democratic officials, top operatives saying, we're stealing elections, we're engaged in election fraud, we're bussing people around, we're going to do it, we're above the law. He's got the newest info, sending people in to bully women so they could stage events where Trump security then has to restrain women. I mean, you talk about setups. This is such dirty tricks, red-handed, and there was Trump bringing it up last night, pointing right at Hillary. So the censorship, the big bombshells he's breaking, new bombshells to come 18 days out. James O'Keefe is our guest at the bottom of the hour. I want to give you his website, projectveritas.com. But we never single people out and say, these folks deserve support. Let me tell you, what they're doing deserves support. I want to thank our listeners for supporting us. But bottom line, because of your support, we're able to have a fighting chance against these criminals. And it's WikiLeaks, it's James O'Keefe, it's Drudge, it's InfoWars, it's Breitbart, and a few other groups. And it's you, the people that are with us. You're not behind us. You're at the heart of what we do. And I want listeners to understand that. I salute you as well, because it's important to understand this is a war, and the mainstream media is not going to pat you on the back, folks, for all you've done. Well, I am. So, James O'Keefe, I know you're fighting hard right now and working with your great team across the country, but wow, what an amazing time to be alive. You've got the floor. I mean, where do you want to start first? The blackout, the latest info, your newest revelation.
I just want to say, Alex, that last night when we were brought up by Donald Trump at the debates, it was one small step for my team and one giant leap for citizen journalism. I mean, what you saw in the last 48 hours, Twitter, by the way, removed me, then reinstated me. We were trending on Twitter. We're the number one trending video on YouTube worldwide. We're the number one trending thing on Facebook over the last 24 hours. What you are seeing is something I never thought I would say. You are seeing social media and the grassroots in this country more powerful than the mainstream media. We are the social media barbarians at the gates, and we have inundated their inboxes. The New York Times is now forced to cover it. The Washington Post was forced to cover it. We are the barbarians at the gates, and we have flooded the mainstream media with interest and attention, and we have become more powerful than the mainstream media. It's truly historical. I've talked about this before, but I've never actually seen it. Last night, Alex, when I was on I was at the debate, and I walked into the press pool, and there were 5,000 reporters, like almost like a red carpet at the Oscars, and they all knew who I was, and they all knew about the story, and not one of them wanted to talk to me or talk about it.
Because they weren't reporters, they were repeaters. You were the only man, the only journalist really in the arena.
They did not want to talk about it, and I also looked at them, and I didn't know what to say. I said, guys, you ought to be ashamed of yourselves. I mean, I said, you ought to be ashamed of yourselves. And it was truly a historical situation for Veritas, and I'm just so proud of my team. It took us a year, transcripts and filming and a year of investigative work. But to see these guys resign, the heart and soul of the Democratic Party, that guy, Bob Cramer, was not some low-level guy. He met with the president 47 times. He went to the White House 340 times. He has now resigned. Hillary Clinton is being asked about it on an airplane.
Now, James, we are on a lot of 50,000 waters, a lot of news stations right now. We've gotten like 20 news stations the last month. So a lot of new listeners know who you are. They've heard about you, but they've heard the media demonize you or twist things. So spend a few minutes just to address new listeners on the blackout that's happening, the huge bombshells you've been breaking, and how they are key in the social media people war against the dinosaur media to go to your site, to go to projectveritas.com, to go to infowars.com, to go to Drudge, get our stories, get our videos, and hammer them out to everybody. That's how we're cutting through the Berlin Wall of disinfo.
Yes, you guys, I couldn't have done it without you. You don't realize how important you are. I mean, I have no words to tell you how important you are. You were tweeting at every single journalist. I mean, I've never seen anything like it. I had journalists come up to me and say, so you're the guy who inundated my inbox. I didn't even know who they were. You guys were sent 10,000 retweets on these tweets. I mean, you flooded their inboxes. So over the last 48 hours, the first video was about the conspiracy, the dark money conspiracy to induce violence at Trump rallies, where they were on tape describing how they took credit for all the violence and how that came through the chain of command from the White House. This is all on video. And nobody wanted to cover it. Alex, it got 6 million views on YouTube, that video. And the second video was about how they were busting up people across state lines, how they wanted to commit illegal voter fraud with non-citizens. A guy named Cesar Vargas caught on videotape describing how they bust people. The quotes, you can't write them. They look like they're from The Usual Suspects. The guy in the video says, we don't care about the law. We want to win this mother effer. Quote, we've been busting people across state lines for 50 years. You can't make this stuff up. And social media has forced the mainstream media to cover this. It's unbelievable. I've never seen anything like it. It's the number one hottest thing. It's become a global video phenomenon. And I could not do it. We could not have done this a couple years ago. And Twitter tried to ban me. Jack Dorsey tried to ban me. And another thing, Alex, this is unbelievable. We had television exclusives lined up with the biggest media television stations, and they all spiked the story. My sources are telling me because they faced retaliation and retribution from a future Clinton administration. And they now are forced to cover it because its groundswell has risen and up. So I have nothing. I don't know what else to say except that this is historical, and I could not have done it without all of you.
Well, looking at you via video Skype for radio listeners, you've always seemed a little concerned, focused, now you almost look satisfied, and I know that feeling of working so long on something like a film or an undercover investigation, but nothing like your long-term operations that are so professional, and then seeing it bear fruit and seeing them try to suppress it, but still it doesn't work and only blows up in their face bigger. I mean, am I seeing satisfaction in your face?
Yeah, I'm exhausted. I stayed up for 48 hours straight, and I just took a nap. So I'm the adrenaline has left my body, but it is something that I've never seen before, Alex. The media is losing control over the people. When the media loses control over the people, they panic. They get irrational. They viciously attack. They assault my reputation. They have to do damage control. And what you saw was citizen journalism groundswell up to the top, and force people to talk about it in the presidential debate, which in turn forced the media corporations, which don't want to talk about it because they face retribution from the Justice Department. And I had, by the way, Alex, I'm not going to say who they were because I promised them I wouldn't. But I had people who you'd perceive to be friendly to us in the big leagues, the big TV stations, come up to me and say, James, I went to war for you. I went to war for you with my corporation. And I wanted to get you on TV. They won't let me put you on TV. That is how bad it is. That is what
exactly. Let's remember that. As bad as Dinosaur Media is, there's actually a lot of good people in there.
There are some good people. There are some one or two decent people. But they pulled me aside. They huddled me on the red carpet last night. And they said, James, I went to war for you. They will not let me put you on television. Because, Alex, the way it works is these are publicly traded media companies. These are publicly traded corporations. And if they air this stuff, that people in the White
House... It's over. Hillary will have to step down.
If they air this stuff, the election's over.
What is it like for you to see Hillary up there going, there's no such thing as election fraud, while she says the Russians are taking it over, so we have to federalize it? That's an oxymoron, doublethink. But then there's no such thing as election fraud. Obama on the Rose Garden lawn, while your video's going viral, saying no one's ever heard of it, while you have the head Democratic Party operatives bragging that they're going to steal the effing thing like they always do, and nobody's going to stop them.
It's this guy, Bob Creamer, he's no joke. He's a community organizer. He's met with the President of the United States 47 times. He's been to the White House 340 times. He's the heart of the institutional left. We just ripped out the heart of the institutional left. As Matt Boyle said, he said, James, you ripped out the heart of the institutional left. The beating heart is now put on the table. And these guys now, I mean, the Washington Post was in a Twitter war with me yesterday. They go, James, why don't you get us video of President Obama meeting with him? I said, that's your job. Why are you telling me to do your job? I mean, if you guys were doing your job, there wouldn't be a need for people like me, okay?
And they force us as citizens because they want our guns, they want to raise taxes on us. I would never have been a media person. But, I mean, I did this because they were taking farmers and ranchers' land, the environmentalists were, to build high-rise buildings on, not even paying them. They were trying to take our guns. And when I would go and speak out against it, they would say, no one wants your guns, and play that game. And I said, that's it. I'm going to fight you. That's why they can't defeat us, because we're doing this for passion, not to be little narcissists like they are. And let's expand on that, because you've got new breaking news I want to play some clips of here and break down the latest dirty tricks that you've caught them in. But just the magnitude of where this is going. They are panicking. They are freaking out. A lot of them are getting more aggressive, hoping to prop up the system, which seems to only be accelerating its collapse. I mean, they were already running, James O'Keefe of Project Veritas, if you just tuned in, folks, one of the top investigative journalists in the world, way beyond Cy Hirsch now, in my view. Sitting here watching them, they're already on fumes. I think we're about to hit the moment where the engine seizes up. What do they do when that happens?
Well, I think that they realize that their days are limited. I just want to go back to what I was saying with the Washington Post reporter. I mean, they were all the Daily Show, the Washington Post. I had David Frum. They were tweeting me, so why don't you release your raw source materials? Identify your undercover people. I said, you don't release your raw materials. And I was fighting them.
You don't release your sources. Nobody does.
Nobody releases their sources. If the Daily Show released their raw video, they'd make all the people look like good people. They make them look terrible. The journalists, this is how they've created a narrative. They piece words together. They paint a picture that's different than reality. And the great thing about undercover video on YouTube.
By the way, you put them out in big 16, 20-minute clips. I mean, this is not really edited. You're just taking it to the key parts.
And the people have resigned, and they've admitted they've said what they've said. But, Alex, it's something greater and bigger than that. We're exposing, like Bob Woodward was on O'Reilly last night talking about this thing. We're exposing, it's not just about Bob Quinn.
You're forcing the media to do their job.
Yes, because it's not just about the video. The video is something bigger than the video. It's about the media. If the media was doing their job, we would be living in a freer world. We'd be living in a more transparent world. And it is exposing the media, and that's why they don't want to talk.
Exactly. Let me take Fovell. He's the national coordinator for this organization, People for the American Way, famous socialist group. They're sitting there organizing nationwide. He's so angry. He's so energized, saying they'll never stop us. We played the clip like 10 times this week. They'll never stop us. We're in control. There's no one. We can do whatever we want. And now we're taking over the legislatures. It was almost like Hitler and Goering and Mussolini and those famous tapes in the office where they're all kind of celebrating and laughing and rubbing their hands together. I mean, it was like a villain out of a cartoon.
The most amazing part is when Scott Fovell, this is a guy who's working for George Soros' organization, he says, quote, we can F-U-C-K, we can F our mother, and we would get away with it. And what he meant by that is the Republican governors and the Republican attorney generals in places like Michigan were too weak in the knees to prosecute the fraud. These guys are so arrogant. We caught them on videotape. They were so arrogant that they could get away with anything and wouldn't get prosecuted because the Republicans were too spineless to do anything about it. And it has come to a point in this country where these people can get away with anything.
That's what I'm saying. They're like archetypal criminals bragging on the tape. So now we can show the legislatures and get the voter ID in. I mean, I think this video is going to change the electoral map. I think it's going to turn the tide.
It's changed the public consciousness in this country. I have heard from people. I have heard from left-wingers. I've heard from mainstreamers. I've heard from people saying, James, that is the most unbelievable thing I've ever seen. These guys are criminal. They're breaking the law.
It's like in a movie. You watch movies when you're a kid with a criminal goes, we're going to screw everyone over. No one can stop us. You don't think people don't act like that. But then in the real world, they really do.
They do. And there's nothing more despicable. Nothing more despicable than inducing violence, than all those protests you saw.
Yeah, let's list what they've been doing and they get this new thing. But, I mean, yes, proof. I mean, we knew it then. Sending people to beat folks up and cause riots that could have killed people, as Trump said last night.
Yeah, the cops got bloodied up. They got bloodied up in Chicago. And there's video of that. Well, guess what? That was Scott Fogel and Bob Cramer working with the White House. Hillary Clinton, I'm going to quote the video. Hillary Clinton gives money to the DNC. DNC gives money to Democracy Partners. And Democracy Partners gives money to people like Scott Fogel to, quote, go out and execute the SHIT. This is what they do. And they're on video describing how I'm, quote, so damn proud of the bloody cop. Can you believe this? And then they send women, and then they try to get women to get beat up? This is evil. And Hillary Clinton, Alex Jones, Hillary Clinton was on the airplane with John Podesta being asked by reporters. The White House was asked about it yesterday, and they were stuttering and stumbling over the question. They didn't know what to say. They said, I don't know. They don't know what to do. At the debate last night, Trump brought it up. He said, you induced violence, and Hillary did not deny it.
You know, since you say that, and only hit this final point, your latest investigation, since you mentioned, here's Trump last night in Vegas.
I was wondering what happened with my rally in Chicago and other rallies where we had such violence. She's the one in Obama that caused the violence. They hired people. They paid them $1,500, and they're on tape saying, be violent, cause fights, do bad things, which is a criminal act, by the way, where they're telling people to go out and start fist fights and start violence. And I'll tell you what, in particular in Chicago, people were hurt and people could have been killed in that riot. And that was now all on tape, started by her.
Started That's by her. Right. James O'Keefe, amazing.
There was another one. Zulema Rodriguez is the woman in the video as well, who says, we actually got her an FEC expenditure that Hillary Clinton paid her directly. She was paid directly by Hillary Clinton to shut down a highway in Arizona. What about highway gate? I mean, this is I have no words, Alex.
The Democrats have signed on and the media have signed on to a true criminal system, the worst this country's ever seen. They're going down with it. The question is, what will their death throes be like? Only a few minutes left. I'm going to play a short clip, but set it up. This is your latest investigation that came out. You already mentioned it, trying to get women beat up. I mean, talk about criminal. Talk about bullying. Set this up for us.
This is a guy named Aaron Black. He works with the DNC. He says that he's the guy that nobody's supposed to know about. His real name is Aaron Minter. We don't know why he goes by the name Aaron Black. It looks like something out of The Usual Suspects. He's describing how he goes out and he induces what happens at these rallies. Specifically, when it comes to women, he tries to get women bullied. And we talk about the war against women. I'd love to hear what Hillary Clinton has to say about this one.
Here is the latest Veritas bombshell. During our first video in this investigation, we introduced you to Aaron.
So I'm basically deputy rapid response director for the DNC for all things Trump on the ground.
He bragged about his involvement in the Chicago Trump protest that turned violent.
So the Chicago protest, when they shut all that was us. It was more him than me, but none of this is supposed to come back to us because we want it coming from people. We don't want it to come from the party.
So what did Black have prepared next?
I mean, I know things that, like, make big impacts. I think of, like, that, like, I think it was, like, the woman, older woman who was, like, attacked at a Trump rally. Like, things like that really show what kind of people.
Hey, Lauren. So we get people behind Trump when he's at a rally, but we make sure it's women and they're positioned next to men. We want images of the men bullying the women who are trying to hold their signs up. That's what I'm going to do. That is what we're going to do. That is the hit.
How do you think you're going to do it?
They're going to have to show up 7 hours ahead of time and wait in line to get there early.
So, like, pretend to be Trump supporters so they get sat behind them?
Then fold up those signs that we have and put them in their pockets.
That is the hit.
That's the hit. Okay, we're almost out of time. You got to come back, O'Keefe, soon. And I know you're a busy man, but you're just a rock star to everybody here. Let's get into bird dogging, because we obviously can't play all the clips because you really don't edit it. There's so much you put out. Bird dogging, getting in somebody's face, you know, pushing them until you get them to fight you.
Yeah, that's how they refer to it, as bird dogging. That's the term that they use. That's the term Scott Fulvey uses. It's where you induce a reaction, you induce violence. And people have heard of this term before. What makes it so interesting is the relationship with Hillary. Is that you know, Bob Creamer, who goes to the White House 340 times and meets with President Obama, and is in fact on conference calls with the White House. Alex, our undercover reporter, was invited to the White House. I could not go because I'd have to forge a social security number to get in there, and I wouldn't want to do that. That would be illegal. But we were invited to the White House, and this is something that Hillary knows about. Bob Creamer says she was briefed through the chain of command. She's aware of it. We have more video coming out where that gets more into this bird dogging concept. And what exactly Hillary knew, and when did she know it? Again, this is something the Washington Post and the New York Times should be breaking, something that they're scooped by, something they're embarrassed that they haven't broke. But we're gonna reveal more in the next couple days about exactly what Hillary knew, because we want to catch them in a lie denying it. And then we want to break the news.
Well, you have forced through the electronic Berlin Wall. We've all done it together. It's a huge victory. In closing, obviously, they've been trying to shut off Assange's internet. People have been trying to get in. There's been threats. They've said they want him dead. Everybody should pray for you as well, my friend, because let me tell you, you're one of the number one targets. There's probably five people they want to get, and I'm one of them. You're one of them. Drudge is one of them. Assange is one of them. So you are in quite the club now, my friend.
They can't shut us down, Alex. At this point, we're too high profile. We got too many allies. There are too many good, red-blooded, patriotic, God-loving Americans out there. There's 100 million people out there.
That's right, and what you've done, you've taught countless others now, so it's seismic.
Seismic, and they can't shut me down. They can try to kill me. I don't think about it. I don't worry about it. I think they're going to try to use the Justice Department to shut me down.
I've been told. I've been told the Justice Department is looking at us very closely, and you as well. That's exactly what's happening. All right, James O'Keefe, ProjectVeritas.com. Thank you so much. We salute you, my friend.
Thank you.
Wow, that is Paul Revere, 21st Century. Stay with us. All right, toll-free number to join us to give us your take on the debate last night and what you thought of it is 800-259-9231. I'm going to your calls here in just a few minutes. 800-259-9231 on this Thursday, the 20th day of October, 2016 transmission. Ladies and gentlemen, there's only 11 days left in this month. And then there's only a few more days, 7 in the next month till it's election day. We're 18 days, less than 18 days. We're 17 and a half days out from target. And it is an amazing time to be alive right now. You're going to see some really sickening, dirty tricks, edited tapes on Trump. You know it. He's the man in the arena, so I'll give him an A+ last night. If he wasn't the man in the arena under all that stress, I'd give him about an A-. But he's the man in the arena. And when she sat there and talks about global government, open borders, this is her dream, and she goes, I meant energy. Well, of course, I've read the memo, the speech. Then she goes in, starting with energy. Because if you make the energy and the roads international and controlled by that international government, that transfers the taxation, regulatory power to the multinational. If you read the TPP documents, if you read the Banff Canada North American Union integration documents, I made a film on it, Endgame. It's free online. Go see it. It's an excellent film. It was number one documentary for a month on Amazon back when it came out. I mean, I put it on the web for free, folks, for a reason, because we need to beat these people. And it shows their statements about we're going to take control of the energy, the roads, we'll make them international so that nations can't break away because the infrastructure will be held by the international corporate board that will then profit off the toll roads and the rest of it. So see, everything she does is a deception. So Trump says, hey, you know, you want a borderless world, or to his credit, Mr. Wallace did. And then she totally sits there and twists things. It was a lie because it was deceptive, but it was a lawyer lie because she does talk about handing over our infrastructure, but she acted like that was the opposite of global government when that's the heart of the treason. The globalists take over your infrastructure. It's a corporate military takeover. It's not the Russians. The Russians are having to send their nuclear-powered aircraft carrier and their helicopter ships and their missile cruisers because the West has announced they're moving for a no-fly zone to attack Russian targets in Syria, and that will kick off the next level, a huge naval battle in the Mediterranean. And yes, I'm sure the Russian ships are going to get sunk. So will U.S. aircraft carriers. And then, before you even hear about that on the news, submarines are going to launch missiles into the United States and cruise missiles, and we will too, and then everybody dies. And that's in the news today. I'm going to cover that after calls. We got other guests coming on, but I kept telling you this was going to escalate like this, okay? Within days of the West saying, we're looking for a no-fly zone, shoot down Russian aircraft on C-SPAN, and the chairman being told, prepare for that, the Russians put up their own no-fly and launched their fleets, their submarines, everything are now in World War III mode. We've gone to defense condition three, probably really two. The pilots are scrambled out on the tarmac right now with the B-52 bombers, the B-2 bombers, the B-1 bombers, all of it. With a crazy witch and a crazy guy that wants to piss on the West as our president, who's running around telling us that there's no such thing as election fraud, but the Russians are going to hack our election and we may hit them militarily if they do. They've announced the new doctrine in the last week. A week ago, they announced, we will start hitting you preemptively if we think a cyber attack got launched out of your country with no proof. The Russians, the minute they did that, launched their fleets and their submarines. Within an hour, they were leaving port. Okay, you're going to attack us? Get ready for World War III. It's all we can do. Launch the bombers. That's where we are with the psychos we have running things. You're like, oh, well, they won't go that far. Really? Every other nut job does. In history, but except they didn't have nuclear weapons when Hitler was around until the very end. They didn't have stuff with Napoleon and everybody else, but now they do. You've got this Filipino guy that's the president that thinks he's John Wayne or whatever. Maybe he's wrong, maybe he's right. He's nuts. He's threatening to attack the U.S., says he's pulling out, saying he'll collapse the U.S., saying he wants to be buddies with China. He's a megalomaniac. He went crazy. Can you imagine if that guy had nuclear weapons? Now, I'm told the military already said no 5 years ago. We first told you about it, that they weren't going to be part of backing Al-Qaeda and ISIS in Syria. But Obama fired a bunch of generals and had a bunch of them pulled up on charges because, oh, my gosh, you know, they leaked to somebody about Stuxnet. You're facing 10 years in prison now, general. And they put their new generals in that they think are going to follow orders to start World War III. And they think in this pissing contest that they can just get Russia to capitulate and get the Russian hardliners to just give up and let George Soros's foundations in to literally teach Russian five-year-olds, little boys, how to put dresses on and to have the Russian military wear high heels. I'm not joking because they can break your will with this. It's a litmus test, and the Russians are just like, we're not putting high heels on the Special Forces troops. And we're not going to teach five-year-olds how to give a blowjob. It's just not happening. And so, and I'm not trying to be crude here. That's what they want to teach in Russian schools. And the Russians are saying, we're not doing it. Then they send CIA operatives from the rock band Pussy Riot. I'm not trying to be vulgar here. This is what they do. To go into churches and piss on the altar. That's what I keep getting into pissing on. They're literally pissing on the Orthodox Church to start a war, people. That's what's going on. They've got a devil pope calling for world government, bad-mouthing Christianity, saying Europe isn't Christian, saying open the gates to the Islamicists. The long and short of it is all hell is breaking loose. I'm going to your phone calls, but I want to play a clip. TV viewers can obviously see it. Radio listeners, I'll describe it, of during inappropriate times when you talk about dead kids or women being abused by Islam or wars. or depression, Hillary gets this big jack-o'-lantern look that I can make the look, but it looks so evil. I don't want my enemies getting screenshots of it and using it against us. I can do it. I've practiced it at home. It looks scarier than hell. I don't know how she does it all the time. I mean, I've done this face in the mirror because I've got a face that can do all different faces, and it scares me. I mean, it looks like a demon. And she goes around with this big demon face, this big demon clown face, like a shark. Other people are calling her a shark now, and it's just creepy, man. It's creepy. And I know I've got all her evil to cover. I don't call her names because I'm out of stuff to, you know, cover that she's done bad. It's endless reams of it. It's just that she's a demon, man. And you know, everybody I talk to that knows her says she stinks like hell. I brought that up. They went crazy with it because they know it's true. Her staff are all nodding their heads, man. She smells like a porta potty. She looks like a demon. She has a trail of evil and murder behind her with a big plastic rubber clown face. I mean, it's like Mars Attacks, and I don't mean this literally. But, you know, when the hot chick comes to the White House and the presidential aide lets her in, and it looks like she has a beehive hairdo, but really it's the alien, and then he pulls, you know, the rubber mask off and starts killing everybody. I mean, it's like a rubber mask is on her or something. And I'm not saying literally. But who can say it isn't like a weird jack-o'-lantern face? And that's who we're going to have as president, somebody with a jack-o'-lantern head? I mean, really? With a trail of every evil behind her you can imagine, with her creepy Undertaker-looking husband? With all his weird crap and all of his weird treason? And the trashiness we now learn that everywhere they go, they steal stuff. Everywhere they go, they steal everything not nailed down, like the State Department furniture. I mean, these people are just the greatest trash the world has ever seen. Okay, excuse me. Before I go any further here, ladies and gentlemen, we have free shipping that ends today on everything in the store at InfoWarsStore.com. You just heard James O'Keefe on. You see the risk we're taking. Wild horses couldn't drag me away. I love doing this. But we need the support, and I don't want to risk my life, my name, my treasure, and everything else, and then lose this thing. We have to shake people out of their doldrums. We have to get people out of their conditioning. 25% off our great nootropic Brain Force. We have a lot of other products that have been out of stock, like Natural Defense, that is back in stock, as well at InfoWarsLife.com or InfoWarsStore.com. Or you can simply call toll-free 888-253-3139. And then, of course, I also have on the site the Hillary for President shirt. It's limited edition. When this run is over, it's over. I will not sell it anymore after the election. We have another limited edition shirt as well that's a one-time run that is the Don't Tread on Me, Lock Her Up. Now, shifting gears to another one of our great sponsors, United States Gold Vault is based in Texas. They've got a great Better Business Bureau rating. This is where I've now chosen to go get some more gold and silver. More silver than gold, but gold is up a couple hundred bucks already this year. And they have a survival bank vault bag full of amazing silver and gold coins. I'm just showing some of the ones that's from the survival pack I got just a month ago. We shot that right here. That's my personal pack that I took home. Will you and your family be protected when we have another economic meltdown? I believe an economic crash is coming, and you should protect yourself with real money. Do you want to be a victim, or do you want to be prepared? Take action with the company I trust, United States Gold Vault. Call today, 844-321-ALEX. They have a lot of other specials. Be sure to ask about those, 844-321-ALEX. They've created game-changing gold and silver survival packs filled with physical gold and silver coins that could help safeguard what you need most in a financial crisis, real money, not paper. The globalists want to make us dependent on them. We need to be as self-sufficient as possible. This is a big step. Firearms, water filtration, gold, silver, you need it all. Horrible food. Don't wait till it's too late. Ladies and gentlemen, give them a call. United States Gold Vault, 844-321-ALEX, and get your rugged double-locking bank bag to securely store your gold and silver absolutely free. And finally, I want to announce another new big sponsor, and then I'm going to go up to your phone calls. And that's Harvest Right. And I've wanted this sponsor for a long time because I have family that owns one. And it is one of the best priced, highest quality dehydrators out there. And it is just amazing way to freeze dry, you name it. And it's something that everybody can do. The family can get involved in it. And they're also patriots, the folks that own Harvest Right. HarvestRight.com, 800-594-4635. Harvest Right created the most amazing home appliance, a home freeze dryer that helps you be prepared. This appliance always allows you to freeze dry food at your own home. Freeze drying locks in 100% of the food's nutrients, so even 25 years later, your food is just as healthy and tasty as the day it was made. You can freeze dry foods such as garden produce and proteins, even whole meals like lasagna and beef stew. Harvest Right sent us some freeze dried food, and I couldn't believe how fresh it tasted. Visit harvestright.com or call 800-594-4635. That's 800-594-4635. HarvestRight.com. Amazing system. They've got them in all different sizes. It's really the top of the line at a price that beats many of the competitors. So go to the original, the highest quality, Harvest Right, ladies and gentlemen. I'm so proud to have that fine sponsor with us. Now, the big debate. We've got other guests joining us, obviously, but I want to also let you know we're getting more into the Russia situation and the economic situation that we've been kind of diverted from while we're watching the election, so that's coming up too, plus some of the new WikiLeaks that have come out. But before I do that, let's go to your phone calls on the debate. Alan in Florida, you're on the air. Thank you for calling.
Thank you. A very dangerous Clinton cash operation has been uncovered in Florida. A company called Gulfteiner has leased the container cargo terminal at Port Canaveral. There's a submarine base there. It's next to Kennedy Space Center. And the company is run by the brother of Dr. Jaffer Diaz-Jaffer, who was Saddam Hussein's chief nuclear physicist, who headed the entire nuclear WMD program for Saddam. This could cost Hillary the election in Florida.
Okay, is this in the news? Because I haven't heard of this.
It is not. It is being blacklisted. They're trying to bury this story.
Well, you know, normally I would roll my eyes at this, but I'm going to look into it. But I remember getting a call 3 years ago from the most credible sources you could get it from at an air base from West Texas. We named the base that they were taking nuclear weapons that weren't supposed to even be on the base. Of course, most bases have them hidden anyways of that type. It's a former SAC command base. Well, still is a strategic air command base. And that they were shipping them out. It was a big confrontation. Then they suddenly announced the next day, that afternoon, that nukes might go off in the Carolinas or off the ports. And there was an emergency with missing nukes. And nothing got said about that from that point on. But that really happened. I mean, we really had this happen. And, you know, what do you do when... I mean, they know who did it, so I can pretty much say now, because I later learned that they discovered who did it. But there was a confrontation with the base police that were private police and the military, and the military said, no, we know we're not supposed to release this, but we have the base commander's signature saying do it, and reportedly this is from the president. And the base commander came out with a big hour-long confrontation, and then the trucks rolled out, reportedly, to the East Coast. So that all happened. So who knows what's going on with these traitors? They could do anything as a false flag before this election. Send me information, Alan, at showtipsinfowars.com. We'll look into it. I appreciate that. But I don't want to get into speculation here now. If I get a call, from actual people in uniform and confirm, who they are, because we know who they are personally, then something's going on. But there it is, exclusive. High-level sources confirm secret U.S. nuclear warhead transfer. Yeah, all hell broke loose on that one. And, of course, if people are moving nukes illegally, who do you call? You call InfoWars. Nobody else will do it. Or you call Project Veritas. I mean, that's it. I guess you call Matt Drudge. I mean, there's not many people that got the Weibos around here. I'm not bragging. I'm just going to fight for this country. I'm done. I mean, I'm just all in. And that's what it takes. Kyle in Tennessee, you're on the air.
Hey, what's going on, Alex?
Thank you, brother, for calling. Go ahead.
I have a produce distributorship here in Knoxville, and I commute up to Baltimore about twice a month. I'm in South Philly a lot shooting ball next to Pat and Gino Steaks. And we're going up to Cuyahoga County on November the 7th, which is Cleveland, Ohio, for your viewers that are unfamiliar with that. We're taking about a group of 20 people, and I'm renting 5 hotel rooms, and we intend to videotape the polling station.
And by the way, that is election fraud central, will be Ohio. The Republican Party basically admits they're going to help steal it for Hillary, so that is the smartest place for you to be.
Well, we're going to rent 5 hotel rooms, and we're going to rent rental cars while we're there, and we're going to videotape from the rental cars. We have to have some safeguards in place. We're also contacting the Cuyahoga County Sheriff's Department, Fraternal Order of Police, and the wives of LEO. We're going to try to stay away from the local city municipal and just really try to raise awareness in cities.
Well, I got to tell you, in Cleveland and all those cities, the cops are totally awake. Look, we got the cops feeding us the info, and it's all gold. I shouldn't let stuff. Point is, we're going to be on it too, brother.
Okay, good.
Well, so I'm going to come back to you. Stay right there. Stay right there. Let me tell you. When Trump says we need law enforcement watching the polls, that's what he means, okay? We're going to catch them hundreds of times stealing the election. Hillary's done, okay? She knows it. She knows it. We're coming for him. Stay with us. You know, Americans have had our share of problems.
Girl, your memory.
But we're rediscovering what made us great. That's loyalty. That's courage. And it's commitment. And I'll be honest with you, in a sick way, it's the opposite of being afraid of Hillary. I'm afraid of the evil spirit that's in her. It's not the right word. I don't like it. It's evil. I'm repulsed by it. But I'm not scared of Hillary when it comes to fighting her with everything I've got and what she represents, because that's what I was meant to do. It feels good in my soul to put it all on the line, to be all in. That's what humanity's supposed to be, folks. All in, not a bunch of lazy, arrogant people. And I was watching Donna Brazile and the things she was saying on Fox, denying and saying basically it's racism or whatever, that she's being asked about emails where she got stuff early on during the Democratic debate for Hillary from CNN, which CNN admits they did. And just the level of understanding I have of the programming she was involved in, the thing she's saying is her own programming being brought up in the eugenics program of the Rockefeller Foundation. And to have actually read the early stuff in the 15s, the 20s, the 30s, on how they were going to program a group of black people to control black people and keep them as slaves, basically, And how they were going to create a new Christian fake theology to control them, and then to see it in action with her, like a zombie just repeating it, I realized she's as much a victim as she is a perpetrator. And I don't know why I'm getting into this. It's just that it's once you get this real deep knowledge on these people, it goes beyond anything you ever see on TV or radio, what people break down. It's like a knowledge. It's a cult. I have the knowledge of their cult. I've been studying it so long. It's like I'm a high priest in their cult, but I'm not in it. But I know the stuff their highest level people know that she doesn't even know. And I'm not bragging about that. It's like I'm evil that I know this stuff. That's why I talk about the knowledge of good and evil. I have the knowledge of evil. But a lot of times I learn new levels to it I didn't even think of. It's like I wouldn't think that she'd be representing the Chinese president and other presidents separately. I was just thinking she was selling out America for money from them, but it's even worse. It's like, I guess I'm not a master. That's what I mean. The depths of these people, folks. But getting back to Kyle, this is very exciting. You got to be careful, obviously. But the mantle of a journalist protects you as long as you don't get in the way of people's voting. And all you got to do is show the same people going precinct, going in. If you run into folks, just act confident, which it sounds like you know you are, and you're going to have some big success. Go ahead.
Sure. Well, I'm up in Philadelphia a lot. I shoot basketball next to Geno's and Pat's Cheesesteaks in South Philly. I've got a lot of friends there. It's a heavily Italian neighborhood. And in 2012, there's not one registered vote for Mitt Romney. And that's not what I'm hearing in South Philly. And, you know, they're talking about the new Black Panther Party locking down all the polling booths. They're a federally recognized hate group. They are harassing.
Oh, I know. They say we're going to intimidate polling places. We always got the new Black Panther Party out front with, like, clubs in their hands.
Well, those days are over, and we're going to stay in the cars. We're not going to interrupt. We're not going to, you know, disrupt it. But we definitely have people. We're going to have them at each polling station. We're looking for the buses. We're looking for the rental cars. We're looking for the changing.
Well, they know we're onto the buses, so they're going to be in rental cars and vans.
Well, we're on top of it. We're not going to have a 2012 again. We're not going to have the Black Panther Party pulling that again. Those days are over. And I think people are growing aware. And I'm hearing this is happening all over the country. But specifically, it has to happen in these major.
And Trump had to rally everybody. And we did it. The listeners did it. And now the enemy is crapping their pants. The battle is joined. Third hour, 70 seconds away. Kyle, God bless you. We won't have globalists manipulating us against ourselves consciously with a philosophy of evil. Because the people running this aren't just sociopaths and psychopaths. Many of the top ones admit this. They have a philosophy, and it is to hurt you. It is to kill you. That's what their plan is. And look at everything they do. Because if you're going to have to do this to take over, why not enjoy your work? Garrett in the great state of Texas, now under FEMA control in Region 6. Garrett from Region 6, welcome.
Thank you. I'm going to make one really, really fast point about that last call. The person who owns the company that owns these voting machines is the board of directors. He is also the chairman of the George Soros company, Open Society Foundation.
Yeah, no, 16% of the voting machines are openly owned by Soros, and then he's got connections to four or five other big companies. Go ahead.
If your area uses these, overwhelm your county with calls demanding a normal paper ballot. Okay.
Well, by the way, Texas and other states have already set up, it's reported, hotlines because there's so much interest in election fraud now. This is good. We're waking up to it. That's the first step in the victory.
Yes, yes, exactly. About the debate, Hillary, everyone knows this now. It's wonderful. It doesn't matter how many condescending little liberal head shakes she gives about...
Oh, yeah, they're all there to make you think you have no power, that you're the only one. Even though she just got 500 calls, they want to make you feel alone.
Exactly. It doesn't matter what she does. She knows. They know that she wants to start a war with Russia. They know that she wants to bankrupt the economy. And she knows that she's going to lose. And in fact, in the WikiLeaks emails today, it talks about... Let's see, what was it? It says, if we lose badly, maybe we should just return the money to the banks. They know that they're going to lose. We need to keep hitting her and hitting her and hitting her. We need to demand for open elections, free elections. Law enforcement needs to get involved. People need to be outside voting booths with cameras. Everyone knows that it's rigged.
This is a revolution against people that took our country over. We're taking it back. Does that mean we're perfect? Does that mean the Republican Party's good? No, they're horrible. But this is a real insurrection through Donald Trump, through the Liberty Movement. That's why he is now our figurehead. No matter what they dig up or make up, we've got to understand they're the organized evil. We've got to back Trump as our battering ram to ram down the door. And we're going to be in a bigger fight after that. But this is the animating contest. The more we fight, the stronger we get, the weaker they get. We have the moral high ground. That's why they're so scared. That's why they say, give up, you can't win. Because the more we fight, the stronger we get, brother. And we've now reached a level where we're like a titan compared to them. We just don't know it yet. It's like this giant titan has this little rat that's intimidated into a corner. But 10% of the titan's already awake. And when that titan fully powers up, it's over. The giant is awakening. Great points, Garrett. All right, more calls coming up. And the lady, one of the folks that held up one of the signs saying Bill Clinton's a rapist, she's joining us straight ahead. We're going to have to end that contest now because $100,000 is about to be paid out. But folks need to keep doing it, keep taking action. We could do one, though, a contest on her and the Haiti situation or mutilating women. All right, I'm going to continue with your phone calls here. And riding shotgun with us is Michael Gale, who... was one of the 100 people or so now that have gone up with the Bill Clinton's a rapist and gotten on national TV with the audio. And I want to continue to have more of these folks on. We have almost completed mailing out $100,000 in checks. This is different from what the Clintons have been caught doing with WikiLeaks and with Project Veritas, because we never called for violence. Obviously, I checked with lawyers first, but I already knew I was right. And they said, yes. But again, you have to say nonviolent, legal, lawful area. You're invited in. You don't trespass. You don't get on the stage unless you're invited on, which some people did get invited up behind Hillary, and then it happened. And then you simply, if you believe this, which they've settled cases, you say Bill Clinton's a rapist or Bill Clinton should be investigated for rape or the media is covering up rape, and then get the Bill Clinton rape shirt out there. Obviously, we're not going to pay the $100,000 out selling the rape shirts. I don't think we've made that just even in gross in the 3 months we've been selling it. But you can buy that shirt at InfoWarsStore.com. I did it out of frustration, knowing they're sending people, even before it came out, notice it came out a few weeks later, to these rallies to disrupt. We have sources in Chicago, the police, and others. It's now been confirmed. In fact, it was confirmed back in July, but more of it's been confirmed, including wanting to get women beaten up so that they could blame folks. So I said, hey, two can fight at this game. He has settled rape cases. He has this long string of it. This is real with him. This isn't made up stuff like with Trump. I mean, we've looked into it. Most of the women's families have gone public saying she loves Trump. She asked Trump out, or she wanted Trump to come to the, you know, her restaurant 2 months ago. So you've got that going on. And so I'm watching all this happen, and I'm realizing we've got to expose the fact that this is happening. So if citizens agree with me that he needs to be exposed and this is hypocrisy, go take over live TV when they shoot these things in public. And within, it was like 16 hours later, that was a Friday afternoon of the show, Saturday morning, the Saturday edition of Fox and Friends with Tucker Carlson, boom, a guy, you know, stands up with Bill Clinton's a rapist shirt, gets it out, and that individual got $5,000. And I did it to reward folks for taking action and to make it exciting and to give it attention and to put my John Hancock on it. I'm Alex Jones. I just paid out $100,000. That's what I do with the money we make to fight the New World Order. I build studios. I send crews out. We take action. We have undercover journalists. We support other independent journalists like James O'Keefe. We're in this together. So listeners, when you buy the books, when you buy the videos, when you buy the high-quality nutraceuticals and supplements at InfoWarsStore.com, you are funding the most effective, no one can deny it, other than DrudgeReport.com, we are the most effective media outlet. And we're not trying to act cool and read off teleprompters. We're here to change the narrative. We're here to shake people up. We're here to get people out of their trance. I know I'm going to be made fun of. I know I'm going to be demonized. But everybody knows about Bilderberg Group and the Private Federal Reserve and the New World Order and the shadow government and the government drug dealing and all the corruption's out, and you're losing, you're failing, even though there are probably, let's not exaggerate, 10, 15 national news reports against me every night, making stuff up, twisting things. Hillary Clinton's running TV ads, you know, attacking me and Trump. It's not working, but they're in this one-dimensional attack pattern, not even two-dimensional or three-dimensional. They don't get it. They're discredited. They have 6% trust rate, the AP reports in their own study. So you're hated. When you attack me, it makes me a legend, fool. Now, I know they got the Justice Department, and you heard James O'Keefe saying he talked to national journalists that have been told the Justice Department will arrest you. And, folks, they can dig something up. They can make something up. The difference is I'm like, okay, I mean, I'm not looking forward to it or whatever happens, but fill your hand, like they say in True Grit. And I mean, at a certain point, you got to commit to something. Because I know the road we're going down, if we don't stand up, is destruction. So thank you all for your support. InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com. But more importantly, spread the videos, the articles, the information. They want it censored. They want it controlled. They don't want you to know what's going on. They don't want others to know what's happening. Now, Michael Gale, SkyMaidenNews.com or SkyMaidenNews.com, Twitter.com /, and we'll put all that on screen for folks. It's got to be over 100 people that have done this. That's why we have to stop the contest now, because, I mean, I obviously can't go over that budget. We don't really even have that money, but we'll make it. Don't worry. Thanks for your support. Even though it isn't there, we sent it out. I mean, we had the money in the bank, but the point is it wasn't budgeted already. I just did it. I want to do another contest. We should have a whole discussion about what could that be, but maybe smaller prizes to take over the media and just show people the power they have. I mean, we can call for people to go do something else, and it'll happen too, without the money. It's just for some reason that seems to supercharge it. Talking to Michael Gale, first let's play the clip of what happened. Here it is.
People still can't pay basic expenses, and too many people are worried about whether there's going to be a future and their kids can have the same upward mobility they felt they had. I know that. That's what it ought to be about. How can we have an economy that works for everybody? How can we make sure everybody gets a chance to participate? How can we help families succeed in the most important job of any society, raising children, and succeed at work? How can we live together with all of our diversity so we can all rise together? How can we be safe?
And it went on and on. It was all over national news. This was all in the first week. This has now been going on 3 weeks, and it's bigger than ever now. I'm told it's in the news. Clinton is flipping out. Hillary can't stand it. This is an example of human action taking over the mainstream media. If tyranny accelerates Everyone should start doing this on local news, county commissioner courts, you name it, just everywhere. You come in. They've hijacked our country. They've hijacked our world. They're lockstep taking orders from foreign corporations that control the White House. We're taking the country back in information war. So, great job. Want to salute you. Tell us about why you did this in Canton, Ohio, at the Bill Clinton rally. And, you know, what spurred you to do this? Because you have a lot of courage. We want to salute you.
Thank you. Well, actually, I'm about truth. And I think we are so starved for truth right now in America. And so much reality is coming at us right now. I was reading, I just want to show you real quick, Maxims of Law. Some people have forgotten about them, or they are stashed away somewhere where people can't read them. But I read, he who does not freely speak the truth is a betrayer of the truth. So I am very committed. I'm really big on sovereignty and protecting my sovereignty. And I just, like you, Alex, you're doing an awesome job and you're putting yourself out there so much. And I have to tell you, I listened to an audiobook of Donald Trump. And he said, you know, sometimes you just have to put yourself out there. And that kept ringing through my mind, And then you came to mind, and you, I've heard you for a long time, and you said, I'm all in. And that kept ringing in my mind. And I thought, you know what? It's time for all of us to take that little bit of action to get America back on track.
Well, you did it. And again, you were one of the first to do it. It's now happened sometimes 2, 3, 4 times a day. It's still in the news. The media is trying to block it. People are calling in on C-SPAN saying it. I mean, I wanted to cause a chain reaction. It's happened. And I think thanks to you and others taking action, that chain reaction is now taking place.
Yes. And that's good because people are getting involved. People are recognizing that we're in a peaceful fight together to save this country. And I just want to mention, too, to you, I was watching you last night during the debate, and it was like you were just banging your head up against the wall listening to Hillary Clinton. And two things about that. The biggest victim is the most masterful at manipulation. And this is what we see. And the other thing is you can't have a conversation, a normal, healthy conversation, when somebody is completely lunatic or delusional. When they're in this delusional thinking, they don't know truth. They can't speak the truth.
Well, that's what I see in the eyes of Donna Brazile when she's denying that she's in the WikiLeaks. When CNN confirms it with pre-debate questions, she's just shaking her head saying, no, it isn't true. She's totally delusional. You can see it's like a form of mental illness.
Yes. Oh, it definitely is. It is a definite mental illness. And this is why when people are a little bit more healthy and they're trying to have these conversations, it doesn't work. And I know that people know what I'm talking about, because they're out there trying to talk to their friends or certain people, and they're like, I can't get through to them.
Yeah, their mind's already made up, and they're in their own world.
Yes.
I mean, Hillary is a real monster. I mean, if somebody wrote a novel about a fictional character like her, I wouldn't believe it, because there's such criminal energy. She does so much bad.
Well, she can't help it. It's just in her blood. It's just natural for her. She's been doing it for years. And as you can see through history and news of both of them, it's like a constant cover-up. And they're lying in so many ways and so many subjects, but yet it's really most important to recognize cover-up. It's all about the cover-up. And, you know, I wanted to say there was a small clip with Hillary Clinton, and I saw that probably about 2 weeks ago, where she says that she chose the emails that went to the FBI. And I wish I could quote you where I saw that, but I go through a ton of media all the time, constantly.
No, I remember.
And she said she chose the emails. The other thing I wanted to bring up to you, actually, it says, I went online and I looked this up. How to avoid going to jail under 18 U.S.C. Section 1001 for lying to government agents. And I read and read and read. And as I read through this, something stuck out to me. And it said, basically, it depends on the person and what jurisdiction they are within. So that's the question. What jurisdiction is Hillary Clinton standing in?
That's right. Well, she thinks she's in this global government diplomatic class that's above the law. That's what globalism is. I want to have Michael Gale back up again for a longer interview, or definitely on the Nightly News. Really smart person, amazing. Sky Made News. It's a cool name, skymadenews.com. Another great activist taking action. God bless you. Thank you so much. We'll be back with more calls and Larry Nichols. Revelation, the movie.info. Chuck Undersea made two films the last five, 6 years, put everything he had into it. Retired Army colonel who got out of the Army and went and shot big TV commercials and stuff in Hollywood. And then has put everything he had into these films, Wake Up America. It's really a powerful film. He's not paying me to plug this right now. He is a sponsor. I just heard the ad for it, and I just really want it to be successful now on DVD. I want folks to have screenings. He wants people to, you know, rent theaters and show it. Will you save the world by yourself doing this? No, but the resistance and that spirit will. Revelationthemovie.info. Again, so important to help get this film out. It's up to you folks to take action, and it's fun to do, so let's do it together. Charlie Daniels, General Boykin, myself, and many others. All right, I want to go to your phone calls. Joe in New York. Joe, you're on the air. Welcome.
Good afternoon, Alex. I have two fast points. When Hillary brings up these Russian comments aimed at Trump, why doesn't he bring up the 20% of our uranium deal that she brokered? And that would really just kind of turn the tides on her and just squash that whole line of thinking.
I know. I mean, listen, I give him an A-plus for having courage, being in the arena and getting some good zingers on her, but he missed. I mean, I would have torn the living hell out of her. So would have you probably. I mean, it was just on every front, he had her. I'd be like, how dare you bring up women again? You stay in the same hotel room with Uma Abedin, whose mother is a genital mutilation queen, literally, the head woman pushing it worldwide. You've got 100 plus million from Saudi Arabia and Qatar, who are the most abusive women in the world, who throw, I think he did say, throw gays off buildings. He did get to some of that. So, I mean, it's just she's so monstrous, it would take 50 hours to list our crimes out. Can you imagine, like, if God was, like, or the archangels reading out her crimes? I mean, how long the scroll would be? I mean, can you imagine that just, like, if I'd done one of these things she'd done, I couldn't live. I mean, I just would be, and she just loves it. She's just, it's fun for her. Go ahead. Sorry.
That's okay. I'm checking my information. Breitbart article, 25th of July of this year. Bill Clinton actually received a phone call of thanks from Vladimir Putin. About the Uranium One deal.
Hillary met in secret, it's come out in the WikiLeaks, with Vladimir Putin.
Well, another point I wanted to make is, you know, Trump is bad-mouthing, you know, Syria, and, you know, it's just Assad, and it makes me wonder what he's being fed, or I'm sure he knows exactly what's going on there. Is that because he's afraid of alienating some of the voter base?
Yeah, that's it. Look. Most Americans just think Middle East evil, bad. In case something, you know, he don't want to. Assad's a bad guy. Okay, bad guy, but you know, we shouldn't be backing ISIS. That way, he just covers all bases. It's kind of like saying, yeah, Saddam's a bad guy, but we shouldn't overthrow him. Well, no, the CIA trained him. He was a commando. He tried to kill the president. Got injured. Came back. They sent him in. They sent him as the head of the security. I don't go into the whole history, but the point is, Saddam was set up by the West. So the truth is, compared to other people, Saddam Hussein was an angel. But he doesn't want to say that because they can twist it, and he knows the public isn't educated. So, yeah, that's exactly what Trump's doing. Great points. Let's go ahead and take another call here. About 2.5 minutes to break. Let's go ahead and talk to Dan in Ohio. Dan, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah. Rob Dew was going to have me on last night because I disrupted Obama's rally.
Yeah, there's a lot of the folks that have been going to the rallies and talking about rape that we've been trying to get on or lost in the mix. So I thought you might be one of those folks that fell through the cracks, Dan. We want to set you up. Go ahead.
Yes, I did. I went to the rally. It wasn't. It was difficult to get in there. It was like a cult-like atmosphere, and I couldn't get a bullhorn. But I stood up on a metal railing and held up a photo, color photocopy of Trump. Or Bill Clinton is a rapist.
I remember that. Great job. In fact, we need to set you up as a guest. I'm sorry that you fell through the cracks. Can we put you on hold and then give your number to Rob Dew, or have you talked to Rob?
I tried to talk to Rob. We went back and forth in text, and he ran out of time to get.
Well, yeah, that's the problem. He's been running around. You know about chicken with the head cut off. That guy's up here till 4 in the morning a lot of nights, which is fine. He's getting a lot done, but he's getting a little bit crazy-eyed, which is, we're totally honest. So do I. So dude needs to relax a little bit. So I'm sorry it fell through the cracks, but he's now become grumpy dude lately. And they have a nickname. It's called Dusifer around here. So Dusifer needs to get some rest. But yes, sir, we've got your number. We'll get you set up, okay?
I think your next contest should be a citizen's arrest Hillary. Let people try to put a citizen's arrest on her and put her in jail.
Well, that's a total genius idea, but then they would claim that I was trying to get people to be law enforcement or they could get hurt. Then they'd claim that I was racketeering, which it wouldn't be. If someone individually believed that they were doing a serious citizen's arrest, they could try it, but it couldn't be for a contest. But it's another great idea. We'll talk soon, Dan. I'm getting you on because I remember that video. I want you on. Thank you. We'll just get his number, take it off to his plate. Poor dude was running around here last night. We ran that big live 13-hour transmission with almost no glitches, so much better than mainstream media. And Rob Dew was at the middle of it like an octopus getting so much stuff done. But now he looks a little like like a wet cat. So I get like that too. We'll be right back. Stay with us. We're going to continue with your phone calls, Mike in Idaho and many others. But the fact that Trump is calling out the fraud has got them in a conniption fit. They're running another hoax that no one's ever done this in history. We've already played clips of them contesting the election, 2000, the Supreme Court, all the latest clips. But today I'm going to shoot a big video that we're going to put out tonight and tomorrow that just proves the media is lying, you know, about Trump and the staged election. That is just incredible how dumb they think you are. But we've got them with Project Veritas and Trump bringing it up last night. It was amazing. And Trump bringing up the fact that they know they sent people to disrupt his rallies. That was in the WikiLeaks before, but now more has come out, and we have video of them. I love how investigative journalists are just backing up the WikiLeaks by going to the very people, and they send good-looking women. That's how they do it. O'Keefe really upped his game the last 2 years. He started getting advised by former CIA and FBI folks who are just fed up. I don't think you really need to have the CIA advise you to use hot chicks to infiltrate. I think everybody's known that for hundreds of years, but these guys sit there and brag their butts off. And we've got a bunch of Hillary clips we're going to be playing as well. Larry Nichols is going to ride shotgun with us a little bit in the next hour. And then we've got Anthony Cumia taking over about 8 after. Always great to have him co-hosting the show at least every 2 weeks with his big syndicated broadcast, kind of getting all that synergy going together. Just briefly before we go to Larry Nichols, Solutions from Science, solar generator system. They got a bunch of products, but they always come up with the latest solar generators, the highest quality, the lowest prices. It's a good deal at $6,000. I bought one from them like 10 years ago, you know, earlier generation, obviously, for like $4,000, and I got the discount. Well, now, because of miniaturization and everything getting cheaper, they can do it because they're doing this at cost or below cost. It's a loss leader for $1,500. So they got a lot of other amazing systems as well. Visit PowerGridChaos.com. That's PowerGridChaos.com. And get yours before they're gone. Again, this is their top-of-the-line model, the one that I use at my house. I bought two of these. I've got three. I got one 10 years ago and then two the last 2 years. Solutions for Science is one of my oldest sponsors, and they're selling some of their Perfect Power solar generators. That's the one that's below cost. Check it out at PowerGridChaos.com. That's PowerGridChaos.com. And then finally, free shipping ends today on everything at InfoWarsStore.com. You can also sign up for AutoShip, an additional 10% off, whether it's BioTrue Selenium or whether it is the Living Defense that's back in stock, or 25% off on BrainForce. These are, I go to the top organic producers of the country. I have three of them. Contractually, two of the biggest ones supply Whole Foods and everybody else, and they're some of the biggest companies. They don't want to be listed, and I get it. We honor that because we're so controversial. But half our products are made by Group, roughly. He advises on the others. And I go and I say, I want what your scientists think is the most ridiculously good formula at the lowest price. And they go, wow, we love you. Other people don't do this. And you know, those companies will have a few things that are really great. We private label whatever. If they got something that's 30 years, bestseller, absolutely known by everybody the best, we private label it, same bottle, different label. Boom. Sell it, you know, 20% lower. That's what we do. We don't have that model of, you know, 7 times markups. It's a 100% markup. Now, we do 25% off on BrainForce. We're not even making 30% on that. And sometimes we sell colloidal silver at cost. So it's all there. InfoWarsLive.com. Your purchase makes it all happen, funding this operation. They hate we have our own model. They hate we fund ourselves. They got articles out every day. He now sells snake oil. If you think BioPQQ bought from Mitsubishi America You snake oil. I got a punch. I need to land right square on your nose. This is badass stuff, okay? If you don't think OxyPower will rock your world, try it and see. If you don't think iodine deficiency is a huge deal, research it. IQs went up 15% when the Fed started putting a little bit of it in salt in the 30s. Then they pulled it out in the 80s. Just Google. IQs explode when you don't have an iodine deficiency. Most people are dying without it. We got the purest form there is. I mean, it's this is what I take every day. I look like a hippopotamus 5 years ago. I work out less than I did then. And I'm healthier because I had all these deficiencies. Anyways, InfoWarsLive.com. Now, Larry Nichols. Appreciate him popping in 2 days in a row. Larry, what do you think of the debate last night? I don't think he did as good as in the last one. Everybody else seems to think he did the best ever. But he did land some really good, solid punches on Hillary Clinton. What do you think?
Well, I'm like you, Alex. I had hoped for, obviously, a more aggressive, straight to the American people, and he didn't. So that was disappointing. However, he got a couple of things in. Number one, I was just with a group of people, and they were talking about he is the first candidate that they've ever seen, maybe he's the first that's ever done it, that literally came out in a debate and stood up for the rights of the unborn child.
He did it
the way he did.
He delivered.
He delivered. That was impressive. Now, the thing that I wish he would do, and maybe he can still do it, I wish he would, when Hillary deflected the WikiLeaks from WikiLeaks.
I'd have hit her with, what are you doing getting 35 mil to give our uranium up, you damn traitor?
That's right. I would have done that. But there's another thing that everybody's overlooking, Alex, on Russia and WikiLeaks. She said she had 17 leading, you know, members of the CIA, all these different groups. She doesn't. If she did, they would be doing investigations.
It wasn't even true. I know. She just made that up.
But here's the thing Trump ought to say. If they've got proof that Russia is doing this tapping, where is one complaint filed to the UN Security Council? Where is it? Where is it? There has never been.
Because that's what you're supposed to do. They don't want an investigation.
No. Well
you know Benny doesn't want to give out any secrets, but he knows now most of these leaks are coming from our own government.
Of course. But I'm just telling you, for everybody that thinks there might be one speck of truth to what Hillary says about Russia doing this WikiLeaks thing, being behind it, if you believe that, then you need to go and show me or show Alex or show yourself where our government has filed one complaint to the UN. And remember, she is saying essentially, Alex, that Russia has tapped in to our State Department's computer network. That's basically invading America. But there's not one complaint filed because they know it's 100% bull. They
sure, let me ask
lie.
You this question. What does it signify Russia sending its fleet in? They're setting on a no-fly zone. Could the October surprise be trying to start a larger regional war? I mean, they admit that's the plan with Russia. Are they bold enough to do that?
No. This is...
Well, that's what I've been told by Steve Pachanik and also some retired generals that are recently retired. They said the military is not going to follow that order.
No. Well, number one, Alex, you have to understand our military is not in shape to engage in any kind of conflict with Russia, even at a tactical level or theater level. We're not going to do it. No officer in the military is going to square off. That's why this whole no-fly crap that they're putting out, we need to... Hillary's sitting there saying, and Trump ought to say this to her. All right, Hillary, you say we ought to set up a no-fly zone over Syria, over parts of Syria, all right? What are you going to do, Hillary, if one of our jets is up there in the no-fly zone and here comes a Russian jet?
Well, her answer is use missiles to shoot down the jets. Well, then they just attack our aircraft carriers.
That's right. You just declared war. It'll be tit for tat, and tit for tat means, just like you say, we pop a jet, they'll pop one of our ships in the Mediterranean. Now, it's just all bogus. It's all stuff to try to hooter us up. What they're trying to do with all of this Russian stuff, Alex, is to try to put the fear into the population and say, golly, this world's a dangerous world.
Yeah, and they ought to be scared because Hillary's the one pushing
like Trump.
She's the one pushing it into us, though. She's the one causing it.
But there now, the thing that is disturbing to me after the debate, now, folks, you're going to see the grand finale. For the next 19 days, they are going to spend every second of media time that they can get their hands on telling you Trump cannot win. I'm going to give you anecdotal, a little thing I just got. I'm not going to say who it was or where it was, but a person in North Carolina went and cast a vote. He talked to a poll watcher that was there, just asked, you know, kind of how's it going? And the poll watcher in North Carolina, this is North Carolina. Remember where Hillary's taken over, right? She's taken it over. Said that the voting thus far seemed to be, and he had been there since it opened that this morning, voting thus far was somewhere around 2-1 for Trump.
Oh, it's a total landslide.
Maybe 3-1 towards Trump. Now, folks, I know that's anecdotal. But I assure you, Alex, you're talking to a guy that helped invent most of the dirty tricks that they use. I'm telling you, I know.
No, listen, we know that real internal polling has him 10, 15 points ahead. Conservatively, there's a total landslide happening. So how do they counter that? Just the hoax to convince us he's going to lose. So when they try to steal it, it seems plausible.
It's all to get the numbers up so that they kick in massive voter fraud. And these votes come in, and it's justified. It's justified. If they were showing us real polling data, they couldn't use the voter fraud that they're planning to use as massively as they're planning to use it.
Let me ask you this. What happens when in 10 battleground states, we have people everywhere, and let's say early that day, by noon, we've already got 10, 15 videos up. It's going to happen. We already know because the Democrats don't care. They're moving forward with trucks and buses, but not so much buses because they know we're looking for that. Vans taking people to polling spot, stealing elections. What happens is that's coming out on the internet.
Alex, that day, if people will call me or call your office, but they must do it while it's going on. You can call me, folks, at 440-897-0611. You call me if you don't want to call Alex. But, folks, we got to know as it's going down. See, the flaw in their system, Alex, is local law enforcement. Oh, yeah, they got national stuff covered, but they don't control the local law enforcement. We catch that stuff going on as it's happening. We can shut that election down. Not to mention the fact that Trump is the first person we've ever had in recent modern times that if he is given that information, he has the power and will push it to the extreme.
Wasn't it epic? In fact, I want to play this clip of him pointing his finger at Hillary and saying, you know, we've caught you doing all this, but also, you know, the reason I know they're going to steal the election is they have millions on the voter rolls that shouldn't be there, and this lady is a criminal and shouldn't even be up here. She should be indicted. Here's Donald Trump last night.
This bucket about fitness to be president, there's been a lot of developments over the last 10 days since the last debate. I'd like to ask you about them. These are questions that the American people have. Secretary Clinton, during your 2009 Senate confirmation hearing, you promised to avoid even the appearance of a conflict of interest with your dealing with the Clinton Foundation while you were Secretary of State. But emails show that donors got special access to you. Those seeking grants for Haiti relief were considered separately from non-donors, and some of those donors got government contracts, taxpayer money. Can you really say that you kept your pledge to that Senate committee? And why isn't what happened and what went on between you and the Clinton Foundation, why isn't it what Mr. Trump calls pay to play?
Well, everything I did as Secretary of State was in furtherance of our country's interests and our values. The State Department has said that. I think that's been proven. But I am happy. In fact, I'm thrilled to talk about the Clinton Foundation.
Now we actually played this clip, which is fine. We do that. But that's getting into the whole her denying she did all this. She's all been caught. It's been proof now in the new WikiLeaks that Obama knew he was using a fake name, a pen name, a nom de plume with her. He's now been caught lying to the public. I mean, how can she survive the tens of thousands of emails, each one basically being a felony, Larry? I'm going to queue up the other clip, too. But, I mean, how does she survive this?
She survives it by what they've done. Who are you going to call? Alex, that's the key to the Clinton trick.
And that's what their people say, and they're having all these folks vote over and over again. They said, look, we run the feds now. We run the media. They can't stop us.
Who are you going to call? You going to call the Justice Department? You going to call the FBI? Who are you going to call? She can sit there and say stuff like that, knowing that it's not even remotely
I agree with
true.
You, but if we catch him stealing the election, have 100 videos of it, and she still we're gets in, call. She's done.
If she gets in, we're done.
All right, let me play the next clip. Let me play the next clip that I mentioned to get your take on this. Here's Trump going after her last night.
I want to ask you about one last question in this topic. You have been warning at rallies recently that this election is rigged and that Hillary Clinton is in the process of trying to steal it from you. Your running mate, Governor Pence, pledged on Sunday that he and you, his words, will absolutely accept the result of this election. Today, your daughter Ivanka said the same thing. I want to ask you here on the stage tonight, do you make the same commitment that you will absolutely, sir, that you will absolutely accept the result of this election?
I will look at it at the time. I'm not looking at anything now. I'll look at it at the time. What I've seen is so bad. First of all, the media is so dishonest and so corrupt, and the pile-on is so amazing. The New York Times actually wrote an article about it that they don't even care. It's so dishonest, and they've poisoned the minds of the voters. But unfortunately for them, I think the voters are seeing through it. I think they're going to see through it. We'll find out on November 8th, but I think they're going to see through it.
But, sir, there's
If you look at your voter rolls, you will see millions of people that are registered to vote, millions, this isn't coming from me, this is coming from Pew Report and other places, millions of people that are registered to vote that shouldn't be registered to vote. So let me just give you one other thing. So I talk about the corrupt media, I talk about the millions of people. Tell you one other thing. She shouldn't be allowed to run. She's guilty of a very, very serious crime. She should not be allowed to run. And just in that respect, I say it's rigged. Because she should never have been allowed to run for the presidency based on what she did with emails and so many other things.
But, sir, there is a tradition in this country. In fact, one of the prides of this country is the peaceful transition of power, and that no matter how hard fought a campaign is, that at the end of the campaign, that the loser concedes to the winner, not saying that you're necessarily going to be the loser or the winner, but that the loser concedes to the winner and that the country comes together in part for the good of the country. Are you saying you're not prepared now to commit to that principle?
What I'm saying is that I will tell you at the time. I'll keep you in suspense.
Now, Chris Wallace was not completely fair. He interrupted a little bit more and was a little bit harder on Trump, but I give him an A+. Compared to other debates, it was stellar. So,
Let me tell you something, Alex. He set Trump up. I'll never again believe Chris Wallace to be fair, middle of the road, or whatever. That was a setup question. If Trump had have taken the bait and have said, yes, I'll go with the election, why would you agree at this point in the face of all the videos that are out there of them joking and laughing and telling in specificity how they're going to rig the elections? Why would you dare?
I guess I get your point, but I'm saying compared to the others, he was a lot better, but you're right.
Boy, oh, yeah.
He was setting him up to make the whole debate, which they've done, about that statement. But I think it's backfiring because everybody knows Al Gore challenged it. It went to the Supreme Court 15 years ago. Everybody knows. Right. That this is real, so I don't think it's going well for him.
Well, what I want to know here again, when you get involved in who you're going to call, Alex, why is the guy that has been fired or whatever that was on video stating how they were going to rig it and talking about the bringing in the vans?
Why hasn't he been hauled in by the FBI?
Right, that is conspiracy to commit a federal crime.
It's racketeering. It is conspiracy to suppress the voting rights, which is what racketeering was basically brought in for, as you know.
Well, it certainly qualifies under Title 18, which is racketeering. I mean, why is this guy not under arrest right now? Why is the FBI not querying him?
The Democrats have established a racketeering operation, they say, to take over the legislatures, to overthrow the country, and to become our absolute rulers. These guys should be in a room with police with phone books right now.
let me tell you about Arkansas. You know why we were able to do what we did in Arkansas? Because the Stevens brothers set it up with the Clintons to where if you wanted to run for county sheriff in Humnoak Town somewhere in Arkansas, you didn't get elected unless you were approved by the Stevenses. You didn't get to be dog catcher unless you were approved by.
And aren't they the ones that own a bunch of newspapers and stuff?
They did. I don't know if they should.
I've never said this. I had them make a run at me, if I remember correctly, about 10 years ago. They're a piece of work.
Yes, they are. You know, I'll give you one. Mike Reagan was doing very well. Then his contract was up, and he was bragging to me that he had a chance to go with this other network and found out it was owned by the Stevenses. I said, you better not. Well, he did, and it wasn't 6 months until he was off the air. So, listen. In Arkansas, if you control everything, Alex, if you control law enforcement, if you control the media, if you control the dog catchers, if you control the county courthouses, you can do anything you want to do because there's nothing the people can do to stop it. Now, they're moving. This is Bill tried. Bill didn't quite complete the Arkansas cabal. He didn't.
But this election has been a beta test. Will the media lie? Will they serve? Will the federal law enforcement do what they're told? And yes, we now know they're ready to go to any level. They'll do anything they're told. They will follow any order. They are ready to perfect the tyranny and kill the republic. Is that what you're saying?
That's exactly what I'm saying. And if you don't believe it's real, go back to Arkansas in those days. It's absolute. It's absolute control. And anybody that dared to challenge them, they've got the FBI, but the FBI avails them to raw data files so they can find out, Alex, anything about you and anything they don't know about you. Or if you're super clean, they'll make it up. As you have seen, they have the media that will go with the smear story if there's not an ounce of truth in it. They will destroy you. They will destroy you, and they will put you in jail. If you're a problem, you're going to jail because they control the prosecutors. And by the way, you catch them in a, let's say, a case of, Title 18, looks like Title 18 felony, conspiring to commit voter fraud at a national level. Who are you going to call? Tell me a federal prosecutor we can contact right now.
And by the way, it's open and shut. These guys are all going to jail, the whole chain of command, but nothing will happen because Loretta Lynch is living like 50 years ago in some weird race world. Meanwhile, her goddess is about to cause World War III. These people are nuts.
Well, and then we've got our safety valve, right? Congress. We've got Congress. You've already seen Congress can hold hearing after hearing after hearing. But here's what you got to ask. When they hold all these hearings, looking into Hillary and the emails and in the Katrina fraud, you know, when all these contractors are getting all that, tell me after the hearings what happened.
Nothing.
Nothing. Nothing. So you're telling me if we don't get Donald Trump in there to quote-unquote drain the swamp, nothing's going to happen? Nothing. All the politicians...
Well, it's going to get a lot worse, and they want to mop up and secure their kingdom. I want to take a few phone calls from Mike and Joshua and Carl and Mary and B and others here with Larry Nichols, but we're not trying to scare you, folks. You know it's real. It's all in the emails, and... it's just a hellish world. You know, the good news is Bill Clinton and Hillary's health is coming down the line, but they got other evil scum behind them ready to take over. And it really is sad to see this country so cursed. But we did kill 55 million unborn babies. And so in a way, if we go down this road in a sick way, we deserve it. I want to see it turn around, but it is what it is. Let's go ahead and talk to Mike in Idaho. Thanks for holding. You're on the air with Larry Nichols.
Hello, Alex.
Welcome.
I just read a news article yesterday in New Times. It was also on Reddit and a couple other sites. Hillary Clinton just moved all the money from the Clinton Foundation to banks in Qatar. It sounds to me like she's getting ready to take the money and run because she's going to lose. Also, she just gave up our nuclear response times in the debate yesterday.
Sure did. Did you hear it? I heard it.
I heard it too. Larry, why do you think she walks around with that weird Joker smile? I've never seen anybody looks more like a rubber-faced person. Was she like that when you knew her?
Well, she wasn't quite as old as she is now, but she wears that smile because it's basically glued on her. It's glued on her. Hillary's normal demeanor, if you're around her, you'll never see that smile. That's not Hillary. You can be around her with friends. She don't smile, Alex. That is a makeup face. That's where they go in with the cake powder. That's where they go in with the adhesive. And they, just like you're saying, that Joker, I mean, that's about what it is. It's an adhesive, glued-on face. She doesn't smile. She doesn't smile.
What makes her happy? I mean, at least there's some humanity in her that she likes sex.
What makes her happy? Power. Power. She gets the greatest joy in her life when she can prove that she has power over.
That's right. When she said, I came, I saw, he died, she looked real for a minute and kind of just convulsed with pleasure. Like, you know, I'm failing a whole country. She admits, I'm killing all these people. Just, I'm murdering. Kind of like Madeleine Albright. I murdered 500,000 kids. All the blood's all over them. Oh, yeah. They love it.
But it's power. It's power.
They're blood bathers. They yeah. Yeah, exactly. Well, we'll be back in 70 seconds. Mike, great point. More calls straight ahead. Stay with us. Carl in Georgia, you're on the air with Larry Nichols. Go ahead.
Last newbie, gentlemen.
Welcome.
I was watching the debate last night, and the only thing I saw that wasn't quite right or whatever was when Trump missed a golden opportunity when Hillary started talking about how good they did during Haiti. He should have immediately hit her with the fact that over the last 6 years, the Clinton Foundation has stolen $2 billion from the people of Haiti.
That's a great point, Larry.
That one of the Clinton, one of their cronies that got a deal with Haiti, they got $25 million to build a plant that was going to employ 1,000 Haitians, and then the sub-jobs around it would amount to about 10,000. I don't remember what they were going to build. When the committee went in to check out that plant to see that check its progress, what they found was a vacant lot. It had never had one brick laid. Somebody in the Clinton circle of buddies during that period got $25 million of our money to build a plant that was never built. And guess what? Nobody's ever done anything about it.
You talk about not being God-fearing. If I imagine stealing $2 billion from poor children, just thinking about it makes me have, you know, get the willies. I couldn't imagine actually doing it.
Well, I mean, you know, Alex, when Trump kind of dropped the bomb on her about it, wherever, you know, there was $6 billion or $1 trillion that's missing from the State Department, did you notice how she never addressed it? She never said a word about it. I mean, that's a pretty legitimate question. During your time, $6 billion is missing from the State Department. Where'd it go? And she never even...
They admit she stole George Washington's plates and stuff. Now the FBI's investigating stolen furniture. When you knew them for a decade, do they steal stuff constantly?
No, they didn't steal it. In their mind, it's theirs. It's theirs. Anything in the, you should have seen the haul they took out of the governor's mansion when he left to go be president. The governor's mansion had to be totally refurbished. They just took stuff left and right. Now, one thing she keeps making reference to, Alex, that we need to get out of the way. She talks about, well, we got to get it back to the economy her husband had. Let me tell you that economy, it was a false economy. When Bill Clinton took office as president, folks, the average family credit card debt was $5,000. When Bill Clinton left office 8 years later, the average family credit card debt was $54,000. jobs were lost massively.
They sold us off. They created a derivatives bubble that transferred power to them.
Yep. And everybody, you know, and you run around and hear today about how great the economy. Yeah, people bought stuff. Yeah, people did, because Clinton called the credit card and the bank companies and told them to open them up. And they would have given a credit card and an open line of credit.
And that was going to get bailed out later by the taxpayer. It was a giant mega screw job. Carl, thank you. Mary, Bill, and others, I've got to go because we have a special guest host, Anthony Cumia, who does a great job coming up. Can't wait to hear his take on the debate tomorrow night. Or that happened last night. But before we go any further, Larry Nichols has launched a new website where you can support him, the critical work he's doing, all the info he's been giving the Inquirer, everybody else. You see the great effect he's having. LarryNichols.info. That's LarryNichols.info. And he's also battering cancel. Yeah, certainly can't talk here because I was eating soup while he was talking. He is battling cancer as well, so be sure and support him. Larry Nichols, ladies and gentlemen, is a great patriot, and we really appreciate him. Larry, we'll talk to you again soon.
Sounds great, buddy. Thank you.
You bet. He's the guy behind the Clinton Chronicles, you name it. And here's the thing. Everything he's told us has come true, basically. I mean, this guy knows what he's talking about. It's amazing. Now, Anthony Cumia, big syndicated host in his own right, censored, kicked off XM, top show there, for criticizing Obama and Michelle and Hillary and the rest of it. He's got his own big syndicated show, but he guest hosts twice a month. We love to have him. He's taking over right now.
Isn't that great? Thanks, Alex. Anthony Cumia here for Infowars.com. A pleasure to be back. I love what Alex and everybody here is doing. It's so refreshing to tune in and see the truth. The truth. Ideas given to people to make their own opinions and not force-fed by mainstream media, which is what we're getting these days. And man, has it been insane the past year and a half with this, I can't believe it's been a year and a half, with this election. We have seen the media exposed for the lying shills that they are. Because, I mean, honestly, before they had at least a chunk of plausible deniability. The media's lying. Yeah, they are. But then you tune in, you hear a story, and you'd go to your friends. Hey, guess what I heard on the news last night? And they go, what? And you'd tell them like it was actually something true. And then with this election, just pieces being chiseled away, whatever was left of their credibility, to the point now where there's not a single thing. If the press came out, the sky is blue. I can't believe it. I just can't buy it. Why? Because of everything I've seen in the past year and a half with the media lambasting Donald Trump, lambasting the American people that want a change from the pro-politicians, the lifers, that Hillary Clinton epitomizes. She is absolutely what we as real Americans do not want anymore. We're sick of it. How long could we sit here? I mean, the silent majority, the American people that don't protest, they don't raise their voices or get annoyed. You know what they do? They go to work on a daily basis. They pay their taxes. They raise their families. They bitch a little to their neighbors, family when they're at maybe a holiday dinner, but that's about it. Then you suck it up and go back to work and contribute to the United States of America. And then as the years went on, and especially in this election period, not only are you told this is what you have to do, you have to rest the United States of America on your back as the working middle class, but now you're a piece of garbage. Now you have to sit and be referred to as the element that is destroying this country. And that this country's already great. It doesn't have to be made great again. But you're the problem. You're the alt-right. You're a Nazi. You're this, you're that. Well, it's one thing to to have the United States on your shoulders, to continue to build and create and contribute to this country. Because that's a good thing. And it's not always easy. But it's another thing to then be told you're the garbage and you're the one that's hurting this country. And that is why there is a Donald Trump. That's why people are still supporting Donald Trump, even after this cavalcade of crap that the left and the left-wing media has pumped out. And not just against Donald Trump, against you. You're the problem. Yes, you've been working, contributing, raising a family. And you're the problem. You're the one they're talking about as the basket of undesirables, the alt-right, the people that are destroying the country and dividing the country. This election is not just between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump. When you say you support Trump, you'll get a lot of crap from people because they're so myopic. They don't see the bigger picture. I'm not just supporting Donald Trump. This is supporting a way of life, the American way of life. It's somebody that's upset with the way government has been screwing us for years. Years we've been screwed. The media that's come out of hiding to tell everyone, yes, we are incredibly corrupt and biased and against you, the people that want to make America great. That's who I'm voting for November 8th. I'm voting for people that want to end these lifers in Washington that are on autopilot because it's the way things have been done for years. And you're the problem, not them. I want to see what would happen with a guy getting in there that isn't a professional politician, that is a proven businessman, that knows obviously how to delegate responsibility. I want to see that happen. Why do we have to choose from this small pool of proven corrupt politicians that have just played the game for so long that people's best interests aren't in their mind anymore? Their best interest is. Their cronies and friends and contributors, their best interest comes first. Why don't I want somebody that says that the country's best interest is up front? That we should get a better America? Why not give that a try instead of electing the same people that do the same things, make the same mistakes, and seem to upset us every 4 years, don't they? Doesn't it just seem like it's the same people getting in there every 4 years or 8 years? And I don't want it. I'm tired of it. And if you watch mainstream media, man, they are pushing for it because they're part of the machine. They're part of the same gizmo that has run this over, just run right over the working class in this country and have just not allowed us to excel to the point where we know we can. Government is so far up our rear ends, if I may say, if I may be so bold, that we just don't have a chance to be exceptional. A small business, try to put together a small business and have it successful in this country. And create here in this country. Last night on the debate, you heard Hillary getting on Donald Trump for making some of his products out of the country. He's a businessman. You have to do business under the rules that have been legislated by these politicians like Hillary Clinton. And those rules have dictated you cannot do business in the United States. You'll go broke. So he's supposed to hang himself on a cross like a martyr for the politicians and say, look what I did. I'm making my goods here in this country as a businessman with no say over the legislation. He's not a politician, businessman. And I'm supposed to make my products here in this country with what you've done to productivity in this country and go broke just so I could say, thanks, I did it. I made my products in America and I'm broke now. Or would you do that and then say, wow, that stinks. Maybe I could change that if I throw my hat into the political arena and say how crappy it's been. The way they've made the rules where it's impossible to be a patriotic businessman and do business with American companies because of how they've legislated and how they've driven jobs overseas. That's the problem. That's what we're voting against when we vote for Donald Trump. I'm not voting for what the media says. Oh, he said stuff on a bus. Oh, years ago, he said this about a girl. And oh, he's divorced. Oh, he had a girlfriend. He did that. I don't care. And most of the people that support Donald Trump don't care. It makes me more angry at the corrupt, lying media and Hillary and her lying shills that they pump this stuff out there thinking that I'm stupid enough to eat it up and go, oh, Donald Trump, he said that. My God, I better vote for Hillary. Oh, my goodness, this is terrible. Instead of thinking, wow, they'll go to any length to put this woman in office, to keep that machine nice and greased up and running smoothly, to continue to screw over the working American and the working American family. Keep that machine well-oiled so the media, who's part of the whole thing, they contribute.
By the way, Anthony, I'm not kicking your, I'm kissing your ass. I was sitting there eating my lunch in the studio watching you, and I've got to just say, this is some of the best 15 minutes of radio describing how I feel I've ever heard. So I'm going to air this at the start of the show tomorrow. You've just crystallized how we all feel exactly. I mean, I'm turning it back over to you. I've just got to say, best radio laying out reality I've ever heard in the last year and a half. Go ahead.
Thank you, Alex. Jeez, I love Alex Jones. I love him. I was watching some of his debate coverage last night, and talk about getting hot.
Like, but don't let me interrupt you, because I want to hear this goal. I shouldn't have jumped in here. You take over. Don't talk about me when we come back.
No, it's
you get back into your groove. I just want to say it's gold. Everybody resonates with you. This is what's happening. This is about taking our country back. Trump's the figurehead, and these bastards are going down. Anthony, we're back in a few minutes. You take over. God bless you. Stay with us.
Thank you, Alex. Thanks. And we'll be right back. Living Defense is now back in stock at Infowars.com. The Living Defense Harmful Organism Cleanser is now back in stock at InfowarsLife.com. After being sold out for weeks, secure your bottle and start eliminating toxic organisms from your body naturally without harmful chemicals. Living Defense uses organic herbs and enzymes to help naturally cleanse harmful organisms from your body. Just read some of the reviews on InfowarsLife.com and see what Living Defense is doing for the listeners. Stock up. Start cleansing now at InfowarsLife.com before we sell out again. That's InfowarsLife.com. Ah, yes, ladies and gentlemen, back with InfoWars.com. Anthony Cumia here at Alex Jones's bequest. I'm thrilled to be here. A little more with the debate, the reaction to it. I was watching afterwards. It's fun to watch the debate because you want to see who's getting in the jabs, who's making the points, watching the bias of the moderators. But it's after it settles down a little bit and you start watching the pundits come out and the news and every talking head comes out and starts their take on what they had just watched on the debate. And what I saw was pretty disgusting, and not to be unexpected. The media jumped on Donald Trump saying he wouldn't automatically say he would support Hillary Clinton if he does lose. Would he graciously call her up, give that concession speech, and say that we all have to rally behind our new president? And they unloaded on him. The media unloaded. This is, oh, how dare he not say the way this is the way democracy has worked forever here in the country. They battle it out. We get a winner and a loser. The loser graciously get, well, how about it's worked that way forever in a democracy, but we've never seen an election like this. This is new territory. We've never seen a media so one-sided. We've never seen the opposition supported by a media that has just dumped dump trucks full of garbage on top of the opposition. And he's now just supposed to go, oh, yeah, after all said and done, after I've been completely screwed over, I will graciously shake Hillary's hand and allow her to literally destroy the country. And they can't imagine this. Again, this isn't a politician. This is a businessman, a successful businessman who has spent his time in a very competitive, real-world scenario. Not like Washington, the fantasy world they live in on the Hill. This is the real world, and a real man who can't just slap a fake smile on his face and say everything's dandy after being ridden out of town on a rail, pretty much. And for that, of course, he's taking all kinds of flack. Meanwhile, there are plenty of instances in which the Democrats have done and said the same thing. One of which being Al Gore with his loss over George W. Bush, saying, you know, that he wouldn't accept the election. There it is. Gore refused to concede election, demands recount to ensure all the votes are counted. Well, I guess they thought there was a little hijinks and chicanery going on, shenanigans, if you will, going on back in that election. But again, all we see is this constant hypocrisy from the left. You can't do it. We've done it plenty of times, but don't you dare do it. There's an interesting story of hypocrisy when it comes to Donald Trump, his horrific statements that he made on that bus, and something that just happened the other day that Madonna said. Oh, the queen, one of the queens of the left, Madonna, said something. Yes, there it is. She pledges oral sex for Clinton voters. Yet, Donald Trump, what he said in a private conversation years ago, seems to be an issue. The hypocrisy is never ending. And please, if you don't see it, take the blinders off. We'll be right.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Infowars.com. I'm Anthony Cumia. We were talking about the debate, and I want to talk a little about these WikiLeaks emails, which just is getting brushed over. So much more important to hear what Donald Trump said in a private conversation years ago, or the nine women, is it, that have come out of nowhere to accuse Donald Trump of some type of sexual improprieties. I don't know. The guy has been in the public eye for 40 years, is it? About 40 years. And if you've lived in New York, you've known Donald Trump your entire life if you're under 70 years old. He's been in the public eye that long. We've never heard any of these allegations. Never heard it. Never heard him called a racist in all the years that he's been in the public eye, hosting The Apprentice, as a builder, as somebody who's dealt with all the mayors in New York over the years, building and creating here in New York City. But for some reason, just weeks before the election, all these allegations come out of nowhere. And we're supposed to give them as much credibility and credence that we give to the Bill Clinton allegations, which have been going on for decades and decades, years. We've heard about these women. They have been put up to the test. They have been deemed credible. They have been battered by Hillary Clinton, who has done nothing but protect her meal ticket and her coattail that she has latched onto for her own career. Therein lies the difference. If you have credible women that have come forward over the course of decades and are still there fighting the fight, and we're supposed to believe that's the same thing as women that have come out of nowhere weeks before the election, put up front by a media that has proven to be dishonest and biased against Donald Trump. I pray that Americans are smarter than the press is giving us credit for. I really hope that they can see through this garbage and see the truth. Megyn Kelly was talking with Donna Brazile last night. She, of course, the DNC interim chairperson, because if you remember, the chairperson was thrown out, Wasserman, thrown out because of her emails. So now we have Brazile, who was questioned by Megyn Kelly last night about her emails and about allegations that she received questions before the debate, before one of the debates, and gave them over to Hillary Clinton. Let her know what those questions were going to be. She emailed a version of a question, and it was verbatim the question that was asked to the candidates and to Hillary Clinton. She knew. And, of course, she said that these emails, first of all, she saw that some of them were fabricated, never saying the one that she sent out was fabricated. Some of those emails fabricated. She wouldn't go out on a limb and say, no, mine, the one that shows me saying this, was fake. Because these things all bubble to the surface, my friends. They all come to the surface. You could lie about it now, but, oh, it'll go bite you in a rump later. She also said that Megyn Kelly was using these stolen emails, not saying that what was on them might be true, but that the fact that they were stolen, hacked emails, that's the issue. Just trying her best. Like all of these people that have been caught with their pants down on these WikiLeaks emails are trying, they're scrambling, and they're all dirty. That every single one of these people that have been doing correspondence with each other, whose emails have come out, are filthy. They're liars, and they're hypocrites. They're making fun of their constituents. Identifying them for what they are, nothing but votes. This, oh, we care about the people. We care about minorities. We care about the undocumented immigrants. And then they're making fun of them in the emails and proving that they are nothing but votes for these people. Again, please smack the blinders off your head. I know that for years the media, mainstream media, has been our source for information. We went to the news. As a kid, I remember mom and dad sitting down in front of the TV to watch Walter Cronkite tell us about Vietnam. And it was, we trusted the guy. We trusted the news. We discussed it with our friends and family. That's dead. That whole thing is gone. Don't go back to the news thinking you're getting the news. You're getting an entertainment show that is entrusted to make money just like Seinfeld, just like any other show that is its main purpose is to make money for the company that's putting it out. The news is no longer there to serve the public interest. It is there to entertain you so you come back the next day to their continuing soap opera storylines. It's not information anymore. Your job as an American in 2016 is to find places to get real information, to get the truth, to try to balance it out with other sources. Yeah, it's going to take a lot more work than it used to. You used to sit down in front of a trusted face and get what you assumed was an unbiased report of the news that you then mulled around with your own ideology and came up with a conclusion. Now they will spoon feed you their opinions and you'll go off and yap the company line and their opinions. And it might sound harmless. And a lot of times we laugh about the media bias and how ridiculous it is. But we are talking about the media influencing the direction this country is going to go in. These two candidates are so starkly different that if whichever one gets in, the direction of the country is going off in completely different directions. This isn't a slight turn to the right or left here. And the media is absolutely influencing that. And it's very important, very dangerous, and that's what we're voting for. We're voting for the sanctity of our freedoms and our rights in this country. Hillary Clinton was talking about guns. Last night, the topic of gun control came up in the debates. And the second she starts talking about guns, I want to throw up. She has not an interest in allowing the American people to exercise their Second Amendment right. And to see her try to dance around it and try to convince people that she respects your right to bear arms is disgusting and just a continuing display of her dishonesty and lies. She does not wish you to have the ability to protect yourself with the best tool available, which is a firearm. That let's be real here. A gun is the greatest tool you can find in protecting yourself. It evens the playing field immediately. You're a slight woman. You're out there on the street. You're walking home from work. A giant man comes up and wants to do you harm. What are you going to do? You're not going to fight this guy off. You're going to run in your cute little heels. No. But with a firearm, there you go. Even keel. You're on even footing. She don't want that for you. You know why? She doesn't care. She's got the Secret Service. She's had him for a long time. She's had personal security for quite some time. And she thinks that we as Americans are all way, way too stupid and way too irresponsible to own something so dangerous as a firearm. Well, I disagree. There are hundreds of millions of firearms in this country that are used on a daily basis to protect people. There are hundreds of millions of guns in this country that aren't used on a daily basis, that sit there, wherever they're stored, doing nothing, harming nobody. But they're there if you need them. She doesn't want you to have that. Yet she's saying she wants, and this one gets me every time. Oh, my God. Reasonable restrictions. You know what reasonable restrictions amounts to when it comes to a Democrat? It's like when they talk about your fair share of taxes. It's something that never stops. It never has an end. We want you to do your fair share. Pay your fair share of taxes. All right, what's that? Well, this is it now. We've just raised your taxes. All right, I guess I'm doing my fair share. They need to do their fair. Wait, I just did it. You just told me, and then yeah, but there's a new fair share that you're not doing. It's the same thing. Not paying their fair share. How much is a fair share until it becomes a very unfair share? Same thing with the reasonable restrictions on guns. Well, that's reasonable. Okay. Are we going to stick with that? Yeah. Oh, but there's more reasonable restrictions we need. That was reasonable, but here's some more reasonable. Until it becomes, yes, unreasonable. And it's always the way. Don't get caught up in believing that fair share will be fair. Reasonable restrictions will be reasonable. They have proven time and time again that once we make any capitulation, they will come back for more. They always do. That's why we need people and organizations like the National Rifle Association, who has been the scourge of the left and the Democrats. They look at them like they want nothing more than to allow people to exercise their Second Amendment right. My God, it's crazy. Shall not be infringed. That's what the Second Amendment is, and that's what the NRA wants for the American people. And they're looked at like monsters. And when Hillary Clinton came out on that stage last night for that debate and said that she is for the Second Amendment, but with reasonable restrictions, I look at a state like my home state of New York. And I've heard so many times from people, no one's taking your guns away. Like, they got to say it in a way that sounds like you're a paranoid lunatic that thinks that the government is coming to take your guns away. Well, they are coming to take your guns away. Go into a gun store in the state of New York. Ask for an AR-15. You will be told you are not allowed to buy one. Now, there are plenty of other rifles to buy. Am I right? I walk into a New York state gun store now. It looks like the 1800s. Lever action. I see lever action guns. You can't buy what they dub an assault rifle, which, by the way, is a scary-looking rifle. Nothing more. It's a semi-automatic rifle. You can't buy one in New York State anymore. They're illegal to buy. That is the government taking away your guns, taking away your right to the best tool available. And that is their idea of reasonable restriction. Have they stopped? No. They are continually trying to whittle down the types of firearms you're allowed to have in this country, with the final goal of either leaving us with muskets or with nothing. There you go. Hey, let me tell you, that's a fine rifle. I own one myself. I love it. But I also want an AR-15. Because in a day and age where you're not sure how many people you might have to defend yourself, your loved ones, and your family against, I want something that might blow a few rounds out quicker than old Doc Holliday might be shooting. Again, they'll paint you as a paranoid lunatic on this, but this is exactly what Hillary and the Democrats and the left are talking about. Reasonable restrictions. Again, until they become very unreasonable. The economy, I love that. Last night during the debate, Hillary trying to go up against Trump on the economy. Here's a guy that has been able to do business in any type of economy you could come up with. Recession, windfall, every type of economy, he has been able to successfully run and continue to run his business. And Hillary is trying to tell us that she has the right ideas. She's been part of the Obama administration, who has had 8 years to work on this. And I love the fact that Donald Trump brought up, hey, you've had time. And that's the greatest thing Trump could bring up with Hillary is her record and her experience that she's had in office. Because every problem that we're facing today as a country, she has been involved with the organization that was supposed to fix it. She's a politician. She's the one that wrote the laws. She has been Secretary of State. She has had the ear of the president. And we have gone down the proverbial toilet under her and Obama and her ilk's watch. And to say that, well, put me in charge, I'll fix it. You were there already. You were in charge, and nothing happened. It's up to you, people. We'll be right back. All right. Welcome back, people. Mega special. It's ending soon. Get Brain Force for 25% off at InfoWarsLife.com. Our Brain Force 25% off mega special ending soon at InfoWarsLife.com. These mega specials help fund the operation in the fight against the globalists. And you could get the best high-quality products out there for the lowest prices. Brain Force already has hundreds of five-star reviews. You could read for yourself over at InfoWarsLife.com along with all the research and other information. Even the crew here at InfoWars can't stop talking about Brain Force and how it helps them double up their efforts. Secure your Brain Force for 25% off while supplies last at InfoWarsLife.com and help support the tip of the spear in the fight for liberty. Absolutely. Hello, welcome back. Anthony Cumia here on InfoWars.com. I also want to talk a little today about Russia. Russia has become this giant thing again. It was, remember after the Cold War? It was cute and quaint when we talked about the old Soviet Union, nostalgic, thinking about Reagan and Brezhnev back in the old days, thinking about nuclear missiles pointing at us. And then we just kind of, Berlin Wall comes down, little perestroika, glasnost, all that fun stuff. And then kind of went away. They had their stuff to deal with there. We had our stuff to deal with here. You know, we knew we still had nuclear missiles pointing at each other, but it wasn't really an issue. It didn't feel like any fingers were on any triggers. And then all it takes, a few years of Barack Obama making our leadership pretty much disappear in the world, to where Vladimir Putin and Russia are now the big man on campus and are able to wield their power and influence anywhere they damn well please. And we can't do anything about it. When Obama told Romney, the 80s called, and they want their foreign policy back, when Romney was talking about Russia being one of the biggest geopolitical threats to the world 4 years ago, and Obama laughed. He laughed and made a joke, and the media lapped it up, loved it. Well, look where we are now. Why hasn't anyone literally called out Obama on that? Why haven't they questioned him and said, hey, what's your ideology now? Do you still think the 80s called and wants their foreign policy back? Do you think Hillary Clinton is the best person to deal with an empowered Russia and Vladimir Putin? I don't think so. Trump is getting so much heat by the media for praising Putin He's not doing that. When you look at a leader that is strong, that is committed to their country, there is a bit of admiration there that you can reflect without praising the person for what he's doing. I think looking at a strong leader is something that makes American people nostalgic. We want that. We want somebody that's not going to roll over. And we want to be powerful and looked at and respected in this world like we used to. And I think that's part of what Make America Great Again means. Thank you. Anthony Cumia, CompoundMedia.com. I'm here for InfoWars. Have a great rest of your day.